Everything's Illuminati. Hollywood, the Grammys, NASA, Disney. Satanic and belligerent. I'm so fucking vigilant. I watch this shit all day and it has no effect on me. Everyone's Illuminati. Katy Perry, Miley and Rihanna, Jay-Z and Beyoncé, Willow Smith and Dr. Dre, not forgetting openly transsexual Michelle Obama. Have you seen the fucking size of what's between her thighs? Like, oh my God. Look at all the naughty symbols. Let me draw around them so that you can see. So many 666s hidden in the pictures. This one doesn't count cause it's a photograph of me. Look at little Lady Gaga playing with a nasty little fanny, covering one eyelid with the little pyramid. I've just shit myself. Caitlyn Jenner, Deepak Chopra, Kanye West, and Kim Kardashian, Hillary Clinton, Henry Kissinger, and Taylor Swift, Emma Watson, Eminem, the European Union, the Pope Obama, NATO, Starbucks, Oprah, Google, PewDiePie, Seth MacFarlane's Family Guy, a triangle around the nigh, and Matt Groening, Odyssey, Greening, mind control, predictive programming, the Duke of Edinburgh, everything on Tumblr and on Twitter that is trending, the Ebola vaccine, yogurt, and Selena, Justin Bieber, they are covered with tattoos. Inscriptions dressed up like some old Egyptians. I know who killed Robin Williams, Whitney Houston and Brittany Murphy. Drowned him in a bathtub full of smelly goat splat. It's fucking obvious when you're as vigilant as me. I took a lot of drugs in high school, some with hallucinogenic properties. That's totally irrelevant. I'm healthy and intelligent. I've just shit myself.
You are about to experience the Drunken Peasants podcast, the greatest podcast in human history. Please recognize that this podcast is designed to be amusing and entertaining, and thus we engage in satirical comments, exaggerations, and even dirty jokes. If you are offended by such things, please go away and die. If you enjoy this podcast, we ask that you help to support its existence by contributing to our Patreon at patreon.com/DP. Contributors get regular access to monthly private shows, special commentaries, Google Hangouts with the peasants, and more. If you don't want to do that, you can also support the show by visiting audibletrial.com/drunkenpeasants to get a free audiobook and access to over 150,000 audiobook titles, including great selections on science and skepticism. And if you shop on Amazon.com, we strongly urge you to use one of the Amazon affiliate links in the description section of our videos. You can help support the show simply by using our link to buy things you were going to buy anyway. Now that we've got all that shit out of the way, sit back and enjoy the show.
Live from the frigid armpit of America, this is the Drunken Peasants Podcast with Ben and TJ, bringing you opinions of the news from an altered perspective.
Fuck it!
Hey man, you got a joint? No, not on me, man.
I don't have facts to back this up.
It'd be a lot cooler if you did.
What the fuck are you talking about, atheist?
It's okay.
You're nothing, okay. KJ. You're garbage.
Okay. I just want to be light.
You're garbage.
And now, here are your hosts, Ben and TJ.
We'll do it live. Fuck it! Do it live! Fucking thing sucks!
Welcome to the Drunken Peasants Podcast, episode 171.
171.
And I don't know about you guys, but I'm glad to have Bill back.
Good old
Bill. I just want to say I love every cell in your body.
Yeah. DP.
DP, episode 171. Milestone episode 171.
171.
Everyone knows.
Nice round number.
When you hit 171, you just made it to the big time.
That's when you're fucking golden.
You're gonna be a star, kid.
Yeah, you're gonna put your fucking face on coffee mugs and lunch boxes and every fucking thing else. There's gonna be an official.
The Goyles are gonna love
Drunken this. Peasants fucking keychain. Yeah, you know.
Keychain.
As a brief aside, please buy the Drunken Peasants keychain. We don't actually sell
We don't have one.
We don't actually have one.
Sorry. Oh, we will.
Someday.
We will.
The fans are clamoring for that one. Like
the fans are clamoring for a
keychain. I do not have a Drunken Peasants keychain. What's wrong with my life?
Ah! They didn't know how deprived they were until I brought it up. Now,
speaking
like,
of big round numbers, though, we're almost at 100,000 subscribers. Please subscribe.
Subscribe.
I don't know if you're watching this. I don't know why you're not already subscribed. If you're not,
make other people subscribe as well.
Force them at
gunpoint.
We're
almost there. We're almost at the point where. We're almost at the point where it'll round up and say we're at 100,000 where we still have about 500 to go.
Yeah, they do that.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
We're almost there though.
Everyone's dead
inside.
What? I don't know.
You're dead inside, DJ.
Hey, I'm wearing my Cena shirt.
Yeah, you modified it.
Yeah.
What does it say?
It says not quite right. And then it also, where it says never give up, I crossed out never, so it just says give up now.
Give up.
Give up.
So that's a Cena you would actually would like.
Yeah, it just comes out there, give up. I'm fucking Cena. Everyone else might as well just quit.
Huh? I actually would like Cena better then. Yeah, that does work.
Mm-hmm.
You're a fucking
genius.
You guys hear me
new fucking Star Trek?
Star Trek is fucking Star Trek.
I have, really? A TV show or a movie?
TV show.
Oh, that's awesome.
On CBS.
It's not even going to be on CBS.
On demand.
It's going to be on CBS All Access, which is their new internet.
Oh, it'll be all over the internet.
Bullshit,
come on.
You know.
It'll be all over the internet.
I have confirmed, by the way, that no matter what, Scotty is going to have to eat an egg.
Yep.
Sweet.
Because Patreon went through and there's still a lot to process, but right now we've definitely reached the milestone where Scotty must eat an egg.
I've ordered a platypus egg, so he has to eat that.
I'm not eating.
So it'll be an egg that TJ prepares. I believe that was the agreement.
No, that was never the agreement. Never the agreement.
Scotty's trying to back
down.
Hold on.
I thought I.
Yeah, that was already established.
No,
I'm not eating.
I'll
talk
egg.
To Scotty. Talk to Scotty.
Yeah,
after the show. We'll get this all.
Talk to my fucking nuts because it ain't happening.
Doom. You're eating the fucking egg, Scotty.
I said I was going
to
eat the fucking egg.
You're trying to weasel out of eating egg.
I'm going
to
eat the egg at my choosing.
No, that's not
I do
fair.
Not trust an egg made by TJ.
I'm going to make an egg.
Look, everyone here has seen eggs, TJ. We know you can't fucking make eggs.
I'm going to make
you can't
you
even
right.
get it in the fucking pan.
I'm going to make you
You can't
right,
even get it in
man.
The fucking pan, dude.
It's going to be lit. You're going to get
How
AIDS.
How fucking stupid
AIDS,
are you?
AIDS in a basket, man.
AIDS in a basket. Yeah,
yeah
no thanks.
Dude.
So as many of you may have noticed by our thumbnail, tomorrow is the day that Ohio votes on possibly legalizing recreational and medical weed. It doesn't look promising. It's a possibility, but there's so many things going against it that I have some information here that we'll play here on the show just to kind of show everyone.
Yeah.
If you live in Ohio and you're registered to vote, please vote no on 2 and yes on 3.
It's tomorrow. I know you stoner fucks are bad with time and dates and stuff.
Even
TJ
is going to vote.
Yeah.
Whoa.
I'm going to participate in democracy for the first time since 2004.
Did that discourage you?
Dude, we already know. We already know
the
youth vote's not coming out.
What's that?
The youth vote never comes out. That's basically what this depends on. Like, so many things. Are young people going to vote? And it's like, of course they're not.
We'll see.
We'll see, Scotty.
Okay, if I'm proven wrong, then I'll be happy
Scotty.
To admit it. I'll be happily wrong.
They did get, you know, 750,000 signatures.
Yeah, but signatures come to you. You got to actually go out
True.
And vote, you know.
But when they gave their signature, if they weren't already registered to vote, they were registered on site at that point.
I really hope people do vote for it. But, you know, I mean, I think that two is going to pass, and I think three is going to pass.
It actually, the whole issue three thing going on here actually plays into this episode of Troll or Not a Troll.
Not a troll. Not a troll. Not a fucking troll.
Not a troll.
Throwing it out there.
I
right
can't
now.
Tell if this is a troll or not.
So Ben is
Ohio
like on the
Ohio Crime Stoppers. Officer Reefer Police.
On July 30th of 2015, a group by the name of Responsible Ohio attempted to hijack the Ohio State Constitution and kidnap
is he a professional
the state's
wrestler
unborn
or?
Cannabis market. The efforts of this group have now manifested themselves into what is known as Issue 3. This group continues to poison the state of Ohio with their propaganda and rhetoric. They want to
deceive
the
poison
good
my eyes
people
your
of
bad
Ohio
chroma key, you
into
fucking
believing
sack of shit.
The mafia-style cartel control of illegal marijuana industry is in their best interest. Responsible
best
Ohio
best interests. In their best interest.
It seems so far, I have to say, he seems legitimate. Like, he seems like he's really pissed off. And just, like, there's a lot of people that are against weed, and that's fine. I mean, I don't care if someone is it for weed. I understand that.
Then
but
there's
it's like,
the people that are for weed but against this amendment,
yeah,
which we'll get into.
He had to deal with that fucking crazy bear who was always smoking a bunch of weed and stealing those picnic baskets and shit. So.
Hey, boo-boo.
Yeah, you know, also, Shaggy and Scooby, man, they probably came through this guy's town, you know, and
he was trying to scare
the munchies
away from the gold and the old fucking abandoned mine and shit.
Well, no, it's because they raided his refrigerator. Come on, man.
Because I'm talking to you now.
They caught him.
It seems that you have us Ohio voters pegged as a bunch of dummies.
I'll tell you what, I don't know too many people from Ohio that talk like
that. Yeah, that's kind of like making me lean a little bit more towards troll, because...
Yes.
That doesn't really seem like an Ohio accent.
You never
maybe
know,
like,
though.
Right on the border of West Virginia
or
something
Kentucky
like that.
Or something.
Yeah. It could be from out of state, too.
Contrary to your belief, the state of Ohio is not comprised of idiots. We are not sheep. We are not politically naive.
This is the state that, in the 2000 election, voted for a ban on same-sex marriage to be written into our Constitution.
So, yeah, we're pretty dumb.
But that was okay, Ben. You have to remember, when it's something that conservatives like, then it's totally fine. Like, well, we just have to accept the law.
Well, now that's nullified because of the federal judgment on it, but...
Drug activist and judges and their
we are
shit.
Smart, and we will defeat you. We will not be let down Primrose Path while you dangle that legal weed before us. We are not asses attached to your apple cart, and we won't be following your carrot on a stick. Oh, it's plain to see that once you get your claws into the legal marijuana industry, you have given yourself plenty of time to make that money. You will use all of that newly minted...
He's trying to say more like a troll.
All right, so...
I am going with troll.
Me too.
Troll
Scotty.
Or
yeah,
a
troll.
Troll.
Fuck you, troll!
Fuck you!
Troll, piece of shit.
You fucking troll!
And if he's legit, then he fucking fooled us.
You fooled us, buddy.
Alright, there's been a lot of ads played on TV the closer we get to Election Day, which is tomorrow. And here's a few of the ads that I saw, the pro issue 3 ads. This one tries to touch at your heartstrings, you know what I mean?
Try to touch my heartstrings?
Yeah.
That's a weird
approach.
Yeah,
probably like a compassionate cancer case or some kid or something.
I remember the day Addison was born. She was just perfect. But then the seizures started.
Yeah.
Up to 1,000 a day from severe epilepsy.
But then she started smoking
weed
every day.
Nothing we tried or the doctors tried worked.
No.
So we moved our family from Ohio to Colorado to try medical marijuana. Now Addison only has a few seizures a day, and she's a kid again. We want to move back to Ohio, but we can't because her medicine is illegal there. It's time
fucking
for marijuana
bullshit.
Reform.
Shut up, criminals.
Get that little girl her weed, Scotty.
You know, that's why, you know, you got to be against these things. Look, that family had to move to Colorado, TJ, so they get their drugs.
Their drugs.
Okay, one, I've read about these stories before. In some cases, it helps. In some cases, it doesn't help. But the thing is that why should the kid not have access to it? And, like, this kid has really benefited from this.
Well, yeah, it seems
like... And she's not. She's smoking a fucking joint. She's probably just taking the oil.
Yeah.
You know, so it's not like she's getting high.
Bullshit. That girl can come back, but she has to smoke that shit.
No.
I want to see her light up a fucking
You're a moron.
Take a big
drag. A moron.
Give that girl some shatter, man.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
No, just kidding.
No.
Just kidding.
I'm not.
No, I wouldn't give a kid fucking shatter.
All right, here's
I want to see a little girl smoking a
Here's a retired Cincinnati police captain.
As a police officer, I walked a beat, served on the vice squad and SWAT team.
No, you didn't.
And became an expert on drug addiction. I saw firsthand the effects of Ohio's destructive marijuana laws.
You liar.
Simply put, they don't work.
Yes, they
do. Ohio spends over $100 million
money well
each
spent.
Year on this failed effort. It's time for marijuana reform. So law enforcement can spend their time cracking down on real criminals and making Ohio a safer place for our families.
What do you mean, real criminals? Marijuana's against the law. People who smoke it are real criminals.
I am the law.
Anytime I would go to the Responsible Ohio Facebook page and, you know, put up facts like, you know, what this guy was saying about the drug war, they'd be like, how much are they paying you?
Huh?
Yeah.
Give me a fucking break.
They're all, like, conspiracy theories. Yeah,
no one came to that opinion on their own. It's like, how much response will I give you, buddy? It's like, nothing.
Yeah.
How much are you getting paid? I wasn't getting paid.
Kid is like, wait a minute. Where's my check?
All right. So one thing that a lot of people aren't aware of, especially even people that live here, is that there's two issues on the ballot, and they're both related to each other. There's issue two and issue three. Issue two was written by the Republican legislature in response to issue three.
And yet it gets to come first. How strange.
Yes.
Odd.
And if two passes, it doesn't matter if three passes.
Right. Two negates three.
And here's a news story saying that issue two and three is confusing people.
Yeah. It's almost intentional.
Yeah, almost like they wanted that to happen.
No, they just want people to exercise their democratic right, Ben. Come on.
There are two election issues which will decide the fate of marijuana in the state of Ohio.
But as we discovered, issues two and three are confusing voters. Local 12's Paula Toti is here with us now to show us why. Paula.
I don't understand.
Issue two would ban monopolies from the state constitution.
Issue three would legalize
medical and recreational.
Shut up.
Issue two shouldn't even exist because it's trying to ban something that's already banned.
Yeah, there's already legal precedent there. You can't have a monopoly. You're not supposed to be able to have one.
Since there's 10 companies that are going to be able to...
It's an oligopoly.
Yeah, I mean, so it's not a monopoly, so does it even... Why does it even count towards that? Do they have to redefine what monopoly even means?
Yes, they're trying to.
The whole point of the issue is.
Am I going to have more choices for my cable company and
cell
phone company?
No.
Okay.
Electric company, the water company.
Right.
Nope.
Those monopolies are. Okay.
I don't think you get to switch water companies.
Mm-mm.
Nope.
Marijuana, but for some voters, two and three aren't adding up. 2 + 3 equals confusion.
I'm a little confused, the difference between 2 and 3.
Me too.
Can you explain them?
Not really.
And this voter isn't alone.
I felt confused as I was standing there.
In theory, it should be simple. If you are against legalizing medical and recreational pot, you...
To put it simply, anyone who votes yes on both of them is an idiot.
Yeah, you're an absolute
moron. You just negated your own vote.
First, I'll vote against my own vote, then I'll vote.
That is clearly the intent of the legislature here. They clearly want to confuse people.
Yes.
And I mean, and I agree with this. Like, if we're a democracy, people should just vote on this issue. And if people, you know what? If our side lost, it's like, okay, then we lost. That's fine. That's acceptable. But they've just rigged the game as usual.
No on two, yes on three. No on two, yes on three.
Yes.
No on two, yes on three. No on two, yes on three.
You vote yes on two and no on three.
Issue two is the proposal to block issue three.
If you support the marijuana proposal, you vote yes on three and no on two.
I just walked out and I can't remember.
I don't remember how I voted.
You just went to vote because you wanted to vote on something. You went in, you walked out, and you don't remember.
My life is empty and I just kind of decide based on what number sounds good. I don't really remember how I voted for nothing, but I just did.
I would not even want to talk to the news media.
Yeah, I'd be like...
If I
Seriously. If you don't even know what you voted for, you probably should just keep walking when they ask of you, you know? I get to be on TV? Sweet. So what'd you vote for? I don't know.
I just voted?
I think I voted for something. I don't remember what it was.
2 and 3. I'm confused by issues two and three.
Now, state lawmakers forced issue 2 onto the ballot as a way to try to block legal pot. Under issue 3, 10 investors have exclusive rights to grow and set up the infrastructure for selling marijuana. Issue 2 supporters call that a monopoly. So actually, you could be in favor of legal pot, but not in favor of it being administered in this way. If both issues pass, that is tricky. The secretary...
Yes. And there's a lot of people that smoke weed, that even grow and sell weed. Well, especially the ones that sell weed, that don't want issue 3 to pass.
Secretary of State says issue 2 invalidates 3, even if they both pass. But not everyone agrees with his interpretation of the law. So if both issues pass, the Ohio Supreme Court will have to sort it all out.
Be prepared for a long legal battle.
Cammie?
Well, thank you for helping us sort it out, Paula. A town hall meeting streaming on local12.com tonight focuses on the marijuana issue, and that starts at 7 o'clock.
Town hall. I've never been to a town hall meeting, but from everything I've ever seen of them, I don't think I want to.
Yeah, I mean, well, first of all, that requires going out in public.
Right. So that alone, horrible. But then, you know, it doesn't even seem like it's worth it, you know? There's nothing really exciting going on, unless there's a crazy... I guess
if there's a crazy person, then it's least interesting.
All right, so we're going to watch a little bit of this debate on issue 3, and then we're going to move on to another subject.
Let's free base.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Finally.
Is it like porn music or something?
You're watching.
It's like pumping the air, listen to it.
It's like it's like that or like feel good, like corporate music.
Yeah, take it, bitch.
Skinamax, baby.
Yeah, take that marijuana up in your lungs.
Oh, yeah, it is like late night, Showtime. Like,
yep.
You know, Naughty Housewife,
yep.
83.
And good evening, everyone.
Fuck
I'm
you,
Larry
Baldy.
Hanskin, host of Miami Valley's Morning News, and welcome to Marijuana Ohio Decides, a town hall forum that is hosted here at Sinclair Community College and is made it also possible by our colleagues at the League of Women Voters, and also it is being broadcast live as well on DATV. During the next 90 minutes,
the League of Women Voters.
It's not about bad brownie jokes or the movie Reefer Madness. This is about serious issues that will chart the future of Ohio.
Bad brownie jokes are serious issues.
Your friends and neighbors are going to be watching and listening to see the outcome of this November vote. And the entire nation will be watching Ohio as well.
Legalize that shit.
Now, this is a town hall forum, not a debate. That was a week ago. Our goal is to get through as many questions as possible, leave
you
more informed than you were when you woke up this morning.
No thanks.
I want to introduce, first of all, our panel. And on the stage, beginning at the far right, is Chris Kirshner, the Vice President of the Dayton Area Chamber of Commerce.
Let's skip these, or actually, I guess it's important to know who they are.
Continuing,
is it really?
Ian James,
Let's
the Executive
see.
Director of Responsible Ohio.
So he runs the organization for the legalization.
Weed.
And he's standing to make a lot of
Tanya
money off
Davis,
of it.
Tanya Davis, a medical
Sweet.
Marijuana
Maybe
advocate.
Maybe he'll give some to me.
Why would he give some to you?
Because I'm helping him right now.
Dr. Gary LeRoy from Wright State University's Boone Shop School of Medicine.
That sounds fake.
A fake doctor.
And Douglas Berman, professor of law, Ohio State University.
Boo.
Our questions, many of which have been submitted by our audience here at Sinclair, as well as the hundreds of folks who have contacted us in advance of tonight's forum via Facebook, will be posed by Laura Bischoff, Columbus Bureau reporter for the Dayton Daily News.
Glad to see that the League of Women
did a field investigation
tonight, but it's actually plural because you will be voting in November on 2 issues. And to offer some clarification there, Laura Bischoff, if you could just explain to our listeners, viewers, and our audience here tonight what issue 2 and what issue 3 are.
Sure, Larry. Thanks for that question. Ohio is going to be voting on November 3rd on a major public policy question, which is whether to legalize marijuana. Issue 3 is a constitutional amendment that would legalize marijuana for medical and recreational purposes for adults. It names 10 locations as the only place where marijuana can be commercially grown. And then those 10 sites are controlled by investors.
It's only for adults. That doesn't help that little girl from the commercial.
Well, that's medical.
And the amendment would also
allow
for limited home growth by adults. Set possession.
That's why. That's a big reason why it's not a monopoly too, because adults can grow at home.
Grow your own, motherfuckers.
And a lot of people I've argued with about it don't even know that. They make up their mind about it before they even have all the information.
Dude, I think it's a conspiracy. Whoa, it must be.
They think that they're not going to give anyone home-growing licenses, and then they're going to control the supply so that the demand is so much that we're paying, you know, like
exorbitant prices.
Yes.
Yeah.
Anyone who even applies for those home-grown licenses, the police are just going to come to their house and bust
arrest
the door
you.
In.
Establish a state commission to regulate the industry.
It pays for itself, the commission, the whole system.
That's issue 3. Issue 2 was put up by the Ohio General Assembly late in this legislative session. I think they put it through in June. And it's designed to prohibit commercial interests from using the Constitution to set up monopolies, oligopolies, cartels. It's also designed to block issue 3 from taking effect, even if it passes. It's kind of a... almost like a poison pill attached to this issue.
That's what Laura found when she went to Washington State. In fact, in the Dayton Daily News the other day, it was reported that those 10, the license regulators in Washington State, said they wish they only had 10. They've got hundreds. The problem is when you have hundreds, it's impossible to properly regulate.
Yes, I saw some people in the chat room asking about the home grow licenses. Basically, you pay $50 a year. Every adult over 21 can grow up to 4 flowering plants.
Yeah. So if you have multiple adults in your house,
yes.
I mean, you can have, like, multiple...
Yes. And if there's no children that have access to, like, the rooms, you don't have to, like, keep it all secure. But if it's a house with children...
But fucking children,
yep.
So doesn't affect me.
Paragraph 5, Section F, as in Frank of the amendment, says, if the 10 initial growers that all must compete...
Keep it locked up.
I ain't got no stupid fucking children,
yep.
So doesn't affect me.
Paragraph 5, Section F, as in Frank of the amendment, says... if the 10 initial growers that all must compete against each other don't meet the demand of the consumer, adult consumer, or the patient, if a single patient doesn't have the strain that she needs or he needs to address their chronic illness, then the state has the ability to add licensing until that demand is met. That's not a monopoly. That's an industry.
Sounds like a monopoly to me.
Fuck you, liar!
They'll just ignore all of that, though.
So they don't care about that part. They're like, so even if demand isn't met by these 10 companies, then the state can issue more licenses, but they just don't care. They're like, oh, yeah.
Also, you can grow your own.
To them, this is a rich guy trying to get richer, and he is trying to get richer, but that's how things happen here. I mean, it is industry.
What do I give a fuck if this guy gets rich and marijuana is legalized in the process? I don't give a shit.
I really don't either. And I don't think necessarily just anyone should be able to grow it just because, you know, commercial grow operation. That takes hundreds of thousands of dollars. If you're talking about supplying a state, you know, with 12 million people, most of the people that are like, you know, I don't get to start a weed farm, they don't have the money to open a commercial grow operation. That takes hundreds of thousands of dollars. If you're talking about supplying a state, you know, with 12 million people, I'm obviously not everyone would use it, but it's just...
They'd better. But this law mandated everyone had to smoke.
Yeah.
Everyone has to smoke weed.
Yeah,
now.
That would pass.
It should.
James, would you like to follow up with another question for one of our panelists? So I follow up with this. The state can regulate and it watches restaurants. County governments can. They can regulate gas stations. Why not provide free enterprise and allow the state to regulate that as well?
Yeah,
I see the point to that, but this is a Schedule One substance, and it's not a restaurant, and it's not a gas station. So, I mean,
it's a weed station.
Baby steps towards it. I mean, they have it as illegal as heroin right now.
Rightfully so.
No.
Is that a question for me?
Yes, sir.
So
I OD'd on the marijuanas.
Again, you know, you have to start somewhere. Most of the states, actually 10 of the states that have legalized marijuana, have started with 10 or fewer licenses. Again, that's so the state can properly regulate it. So starting at 10 is not a magic number, but it does establish the floor. The state and the market demand establishes the ceiling. So if you're looking for the best possible number, what is that number? I don't know that you'll ever come up with it. But I can tell you this, that the patients
that need medical
marijuana
decide,
that are suffering
bitch.
From cancer, the kids that have epilepsy, the folks that have family members with Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease, our veterans
so
that have post-traumatic stress
someone,
disorder, they need medical...
Someone in the chat said, so someone can open a winery, but the same thing doesn't apply to weed. Well, you know, alcohol was illegal for like a decade, and when it became legal again, they didn't just allow anyone to make it right away.
No.
They had to make transitional steps, and that's what I was saying earlier. We're going, we have a substance that's as illegal as heroin. We all agree is that it's not as dangerous as heroin.
Yeah, let's move forward with something.
The weed makes me want to murder.
People just want the status quo, and it's like it always seems to be this way in America. It's like, oh, there's some problems with it, so let's just do nothing.
Why don't you just fucking die, bitch?
Why don't you make
I'm
me,
all
bitch?
I'm hopped up on the Mary Jane.
Why don't you fucking make me then?
Now you're gonna die.
Stop.
I can't help it. I can't control myself. I'm the marijuana.
Marijuana. And they get that with the SM3 vote. And it establishes a system that actually does allow the state to regulate it properly. Now, if you want to have 11, and you can get there, if these 10...
Yeah, I like this whole marijuana legalization thing, but his white coat is pissing me off, man.
In the...
He looks like Forrest Gump.
In the state of Ohio, if you get convicted of any drug offense, they take away your driver's license. Even if you weren't driving, if you were, you know, sitting down on a park bench and somehow a cop smelled weed on you and you happened to have weed and they searched you, because they can use scent as probable cause for anything, then you will lose your driver's license for 6 months. And people that live in Ohio know that public transportation doesn't cut it here.
Barely exists.
Yeah.
Don't meet the demand. And most of these folks, I think, will say, or a lot of these folks will probably say, you know what? I don't think they will meet the demand. And if they don't, then the market takes over. And that
No, you'll keep it low.
No, it'll never happen.
The supply will be low.
It starts at 10, it grows from there.
All right, thank you. Ian, Laura, do you have a question?
Yeah, let's shift gears here a little bit. Ian just talked about all the diseases.
I
want to
hear from the guy who's like really against it because he's a ridiculous motherfucker.
So, you know, marijuana
is
considered
professor?
A controlled
no,
substance by
the law professor helped draft the amendment.
I think it's probably Chamber of Commerce guy.
Doctors don't prescribe it.
Yeah.
Even in states with medical marijuana, they do kind of...
You know why he's mad? Because banks won't touch this money.
Yeah, it's true.
Because
it's still, even if it was legal here, it'd still be illegal under federal law. Yeah.
Fucking federal law and it's shit.
So my question, I guess, to Dr. Leroy or to Ms. Davis is, you know, is it medicine? Is it safe? What are the benefits?
So, again, from the health standpoint, a number of states have actually legalized medical
we know
marijuana.
This.
I'm hearing
I
kind
am
of
extremely
dual
soft-spoken,
things here.
And I'm just going to talk
that's one
back
issue
this.
In medical marijuana. Because it is a Schedule I, not even a medication, a Schedule I drug, basically very little research has been done on it. It's illegal.
It's illegal.
Got a standing
yeah.
ovation for it.
Yeah.
It's illegal. Yeah.
You know,
it's illegal.
You know, we've known about it for so long and very little research has been done. Why is that?
I've done some research.
Welcome back to Marijuana Ohio Decides, a town hall forum. I'm Larry Hansgen, and we are joined again by an outstanding panel of experts, Chris Kirshner, the Vice President of the Dayton Area Chamber of Commerce, Ian James,
my doctor would recommend me using it. My doctor supports this,
this
issue.
This lady's crazy.
My doctor would rather see me use cannabis than use oxycodone.
Oxycodone.
And I've been on both
Why
of those
not
drugs.
Both? Yeah, me too.
At the same time.
Fentanyl patches.
No, I'm not morphine, but oxycodone's pretty close.
You know,
pretty close.
One of the things that I have learned through all this is marijuana or cannabis should not be a Schedule I drug.
You lie!
There is no way.
Boo!
Druggy, go
You're
back,
a monster.
Go back to goddamn Oregon.
Go inject more of your marijuanas, you fucking
yeah.
psycho.
Hippie, these hippy-dippy liberals ruin this country.
And I'm not saying I'm all for the RO plan. I've got some problems with it.
Yeah,
but
monopoly.
Legalization will open up the doors for our physicians.
See, this is a smart person. She disagrees with the law, but she understands that it should pass for the good of all of these people.
For the good of the land.
For the good of me.
And our scientists and our doctors to study it. And we'll open the doors up to, so that medicine can be given to the ones that need it the most.
No.
I do not believe anyone should
to use
One area of concern seems to be business concerns or employer concerns.
I wonder if the Pink Floyd guy with a giant beard behind her is
generally
marijuana.
Speaking,
I wonder where he stands on the issue.
How are employers going to handle issues
I don't know.
If it passes? How will it conflict?
He could be one of those people that's like, I don't want the rich to get richer. We should do it like Colorado.
With their drug-free workplace policies. What's the general feeling on that?
Thanks. There's some very serious concerns from the business community.
I am
the
living
turd. Community, those concerns are around, one of those concerns
how would,
is around
how
a piece of the amendment
around
that
guy?
Says employers will be constitutionally mandated
in our,
to allow
in our business group don't want this, so we're against it.
Medical
you know.
Marijuana.
Well, because you think about it, like, look, all these other businesses, you have these people own restaurants and own bars and places. They don't want legal weed. It doesn't benefit them. And not to mention, I guarantee this guy is some fucking right-wing conservative asshole who just thinks, like, people that smoke weed are, like, you know, junkies on the, like, in the gutter,
yeah.
in an alley, you know. It's like, come on, people that smoke weed are not like that.
I'm pretty sure Bill Gates has smoked weed before.
I mean, I'm sure there are people who are junkies that smoke
I'm
weed.
I'm sure there's,
but,
like, very successful people who have smoked weed. I'm sure Steve Jobs smoked weed.
And he also did acid.
Yeah.
I mean, there's varying degrees of drug use. There's people who are called recreational drug users, and there's people who are addicted. And
Richard Branson, you ever take a look at that dude? You know he smoked weed before.
That guy's probably smoking a doobie all the time.
He's probably smoking one right now.
Probably smoking a fucking fatty right
Sir
now.
Sir Richard Branson getting
on his island.
Yeah.
In the workplace.
Boo.
Please don't take that statement as any disrespect to folks that are using medical marijuana. However, when you force an employer to do that and they have a drug-free workplace policy, they are now either in conflict of their drug-free workplace policy to uphold the Constitution, or they're going to be in conflict with the Constitution
no,
to uphold
that's actually
their drug-free
not true.
Workplace
this has
policy.
Been,
either
this has already been
this is
done
right,
in Colorado.
Ohio.
Colorado decided on a federal – basically, it went to federal court, and they decided that federal law superseded the state law, so you would just be fired.
Plus Ohio is an at-will state anyway. They can fire you for any reason they want. And there's plenty of employers that don't let people who smoke work for them, and that's a legal drug. So
yeah.
this is all bullshit, this argument that now employers are going to be put in a difficult situation.
Employers are already being put in that situation because, it's already – there's already people smoking weed, you know? They already do drug tests and shit.
It's a waste of money. You know how much
Nothing
money they
change.
Waste on drug tests? It's unbelievable.
Way that employer set up it for some very serious legal challenges that are going to cost that employer a ton of money, which is going to prevent them from hiring more jobs, which is going to prevent their investments
hiring
in this area.
Hiring more jobs?
Hire more jobs.
I thought you hired people, not jobs. I'm going to hire some more jobs, you know, soon.
Maybe he's talking about people whose last name is Jobs.
Oh.
Yeah. That's just one issue. That's just one issue. There's other issues in regards to employee
Next.
Productivity. employee legal liabilities, American, challenges, drug
American
screening.
American productivity is at an all-time high, pretty much, so that's not even a question.
You know what else is at an all-time high? Me. No, not right now. But
no.
It was just, I mean, you could do far more with far less people now. I mean, liability, sure. I mean, do I think someone that's driving a truck should be fucking stoned out of their minds? Like, obviously not, but we have to consider it, like, I would say on a case-by-case basis.
I think it's bullshit how cautious we are about it.
I'm pretty
it.
Sure someone who's stoned could still make my sandwich at Subway.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Dude, they fucking definitely have made your sandwich stoned before.
Cost, hiring practices, there's a lot of things employers have to take into account. This isn't as simple as it seems on the surface.
Yes, yes it is.
James?
In fact, it should be simpler, but it has to be complicated for some reason.
Mr. James, I see you shaking your head in disagreement. I'm going to let you respond to that, but the follow-up question is, hypothetically speaking, let's say somebody has smoked marijuana over the weekend. They show up at work on Monday. They're required to take a drug test, and marijuana shows up in their system. They might not legally be
impaired.
Under the influence, impaired, but it puts the employer in a difficult situation moving forward. Your thoughts?
No, the employer can do whatever the fuck they want.
You have the Cleveland Clinic, you have Scott's Miracle-Gro, you have the Cincinnati Zoo, and Longaberger Basket all have a policy right now on a legal substance that they prohibit the use of. So anybody that is coming in to apply for a job or has a job there isn't permitted to use it. And if they do, they're not hired or they're fired. And that legal substance today, sir, is nicotine. And so the fact that Chris raises this, it's a red herring. It's really ridiculous because, in fact, if you are a drug-free workplace today, you're a drug-free workplace afterwards. What you're referencing, Chris, is in fact a section that says that if you're a medical marijuana patient, you have the right to self-medicate. The difference, though, is because it's established law, whether or not we like it or not, it is established law, the court has upheld it, that you cannot change an employer's policies on drug-free workplace, zero-tolerance workplace, if whether or not you are a medical marijuana patient.
All right, so that guy's whole argument was just destroyed.
Bunk. Total bunk. This guy just took a big shit on it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great. Sitting right next to him, too. So he has to sit there and just be like, nope, yeah. You're wrong.
I think we can move on.
Yeah.
But, yes, please.
If you live in this state, no on two, yes on three.
No on two, yes on three.
Me and TJ are going to vote tomorrow,
no on
so.
Two, yes on three.
I've already voted.
Two, yes
if our lazy asses can do it, if you live here, just go do it.
No on fucking two, yes on fucking three,
yes.
You pieces of goddamn shit.
And if you're one of those people that smokes weed and you're going to vote no on three no matter what, please vote no on two. Also.
Yeah, even if you're going to be stupid enough to vote no on three, vote no on two as well because, you know,
yeah.
It fucks us in the
Come
ass
on.
Real bad.
Yep. All right. Let's see. Here's a news story about the GOP candidates, because there's so many of them.
Ugh.
And they all want equal fucking time.
No.
Yeah, well, they're not all equally interesting.
I know.
So, fuck them.
Yeah.
Yeah, some of these guys have no chance of being president, so.
In New Hampshire. A new Monmouth University poll shows Trump with 26% support from Republicans, a 10-point lead over Dr. Ben Carson in second.
Well, it's interesting.
After a strong debate performance,
can we just
Marco
limit this
Rubio
to like fucking
surges
five.
To third, tripling his support since
yeah,
September.
See, if you had those
Today,
four or five guys, that's fine.
He also picked up an endorsement from freshman Senator Cory Gardner.
Yeah, all these like
now the Republican
1% of the fucking vote candidates and shit just need to go. Like Jeb's ass needs to just quit.
Yeah.
No one's going to fucking
fuck Rand
vote
Paul,
for stupid
fuck
fucking
Chris
Jeb.
Christie. Fuck Ted
excuse
Cruz.
Me, it's Chris Crispy.
What's the woman from HP?
Carly Fiorina?
Fiorina.
Fiorina.
Something like that.
We're terrible at last names.
She has no traction whatsoever.
She's a turd. And
I mean, even Michelle Bachmann was leading in the polls at one point when she ran.
Yes, yeah, so, I mean, Donald Trump has been the number one candidate for quite some time. I mean,
they're not even that much different. It's like, which flavor of dog shit do you want to eat? Come on.
Occasionally a poll will come out that puts Carson ahead of Trump, but overall, Trump's ahead in most of the polls. He's been a consistent front runner for quite some time now. I would say that he stands a good chance of getting the nomination. So does Carson.
I mean, Carson just shows you the state of the Republican Party when you have a fucking flat earth creation. It's just like, yep.
Is he a flat earth or what?
Oh, I thought he was flat earth. That might not be true, but he is a fucking, he is a creationist.
That's just as bad.
Yeah.
Field is tackling a new challenge, reforming the structure of their presidential debates.
Is this a comic book version of a presidential campaign?
It's not a comic book, and it's not a very nicely asked question the way you say that.
After last week's CNBC
you asked me a mean question.
You ain't nice.
What does this hat say? See America.
Make America great again.
Okay, make America great again.
It should be on Wheel of Fortune.
And on Sunday, to determine exactly how their candidates can exert control over how the debates are run.
I'll find out if we can reach some consensus on what the debates should look like.
Now those campaigns have drafted a letter for debate sponsors with their demands.
The fucking
like keeping debates under 2 hours and giving candidates...
So just get rid of Chris Crispy then?
No, cut about half the field because none of these guys have even have a fucking chance anyways. I mean, what fucking point is it to have all these people? It's like, well, Rand Paul's going to get the nomination. You know, I mean, come on. These people have been the public eye for a while now. I think people are starting to basically start coalescing around, like, one candidate.
And I watched that last debate that they had, and it was funny because, like, all nine of them are standing up there, and they're like, this debate was much better than the Democrats' debate. At least we talked about things. And it's like, what? There was like nine of you, and you're all talking over each other, and it's ridiculous.
Yeah, I mean, I honestly thought the Democratic debate was remarkably substantive, way more than I thought it was going to be. The Republican debates I've watched so far have pretty much just been mudslinging contests. I remember in the debate before this one, they spent like 30 minutes just talking about Planned Parenthood. Like, is that a big issue? No.
No.
No one gives a fuck.
Yeah, in a world with climate change, ISIS, political instability.
You live in a world of climate change. They live in a world where the jury's out on climate change, okay?
The climate is actually fine.
And if there is climate change, it's because we let gays marry.
Yeah, they hate gay marriage, and what is their other pet issue right now besides Planned Parenthood? Oh yeah, they're gonna cut the deficit.
They're gonna
fund the military some more.
The things that they want to cut are things that we spend hardly any money on, like PBS and Planned Parenthood and shit like that. But don't take any money away from the military where we're building like aircraft carriers and fucking fighter jets.
If you look at the US federal budget, you can see that a lot of the stuff is already written to law. They have to spend the money on it, like Medicare, Social Security, etc. So you can't just do away with that. So if you can't say, okay, we're just gonna take care of this. Like, so the Republicans want to go after anything that's domestic and just keep funding the military. We need to fund the military
taxes
more.
Taxes are stealing, Scotty. Taxes are theft.
Not according to the Constitution.
Theft!
For opening and closing statements.
May not get everything in one big bite, but we're making progress. That's the
important. Is this guy hawking a fucking book, too?
Yeah, he is.
He's
so soft-spoken, but he did try to stab someone when he was 14, so.
But I just find it kind of funny. It's like, vote for me, and oh, by the way, buy my book.
I don't know if you guys saw that interview, but there was something where people said, like, you know, you're pretty low energy. And he's like, you know, when I was 14, I tried to stab a guy. I'm like,
how comforting.
Okay.
So don't fuck with me.
Doesn't really seem like presidential criteria, but all right.
The president you would at least trust in an alleyway.
You know, by the time the next election happens,
nipple piss,
I will be old enough to run for president. So technically, this is the first presidential election where I'm actually old enough to be eligible to run for president.
You should run for president, Ben.
Fuck no. Well, I couldn't do it this time anyway.
Run for president.
Not that I would ever do that. That's retarded.
Come on, Ben. Be president.
No.
We're going to make every state an amusement park.
Yeah.
We got a pot of gold here in the U.S.
Waka laka daka schmaka daka laka baka la.
And if I don't win this election...
Jesus told me just now.
Jesus is going to fuck you up.
Damn. Jesus is going to come down and fucking burn America to ashes unless you guys elect Ben president.
Of the world.
Of the universe.
Consensus on a few issues.
Emperor.
Each campaign is using the moment to play to their candidates' strengths and downplay their weaknesses.
I like how they put up Jeb when they talk about weaknesses. They're like, they're weaknesses. Jeb just is one big weakness.
I mean, I really think that Jeb, for the most part, has almost no support. He's just using that, like, those services like Rent a Crowd, because I can't imagine anyone being excited to see Jeb Bush speak.
Oh my God, we're gonna see Jeb!
It's
we're
like,
gonna
man,
see Jeb!
Like, you hear tales about Abraham Lincoln stumping, you know, the Lincoln-Douglas debates, and you just think, you know who could even top that? Would just be Jeb Bush. You know, Jesus fucking Christ, I need to see Jeb Bush speak. Yo, come on.
You know, maybe it's like when someone tells you, like, hey, you know, my friend, they got this huge open sore on their leg with gangrene and shit. You want to come see? And people are like, I guess. I'm morbidly curious. Maybe it's the same thing bringing people to Jeb Bush rallies, you know? He's basically just an open sore.
It's like John Kasich and Jeb.
Who looks like Gary Shandling, by the way. Not Jeb.
Gary Shandling.
John Kasich.
Yeah, he does.
I've not heard that in a while.
He looks Gary like Gary fucking Shandling.
He does. Really
think so. I think... John Kasich, you think, looks like Gary Shandling?
Yeah.
At least a little bit, yeah.
Yeah, man. Yeah, I think he does.
Bush, want more speaking time.
Whatever the rules are.
Plus, he wears glasses. What a nerd.
This guy's a fucking
some
dork.
Nerd president that can't even afford LASIK eye surgery.
They should keep to him. That's all I think the candidates want. The rules were established, and they lost control over the entire process last time.
Shut up, you
turd.
I
know that Harry Truman.
You do not think he looks like Gary Shandling.
Yeah, he does.
There are some differences.
Well, I'm not saying they're his fucking clone or something.
Gary Shandling has a drastically larger nose.
What are you saying, Ben?
That his nose is larger.
Okay.
Couldn't get elected president with explaining United States of America's health care plan in 30 seconds.
While those competing for more conservative
what a stupid
voters
standard.
Want to see different
moderates. You try to explain something that's at all complex to me
look
in 30
that
seconds.
Don't you just want a lighting rig to fall on him?
He's so fucking phony. He doesn't want to raise his hand up. He's just like, why am I here? Well, I need these fucking simpletons. Yeah. I need these simpletons to fucking vote for my fucking simpering little... Oh, God, he's a fucking rat. He's a fucking rat. And you just want to fucking... It's like, you know what? You want the ship to light on fire so you can see him scurry away. Scurry back to Canada, you fucking rat.
If you have never voted in a Republican primary in your life...
Don't start now.
Go back to fucking Canada where you belong, you ugly
debate.
Sack of shit.
And some are already sick of
go
the
back to Krispy Kreme where you fucking belong.
The debate format is just fine.
We're here in Iowa talking to voters instead of being in D.C.
Fuck about
does she look like she's had plastic surgery or something?
Even maybe Botox. I fucking love these assholes that go there and it's like, we're here to talk to the common voter and just get there. Like, you don't give a fuck what the common voter thinks. Just look at the public policy in the U.S. It's so clear that the middle class and the poor people are just totally ignored by politicians because they're not fucking funding their campaigns. So why what incentive would they have to listen to them?
Shut up, Scotty.
We've had no trouble negotiating with the networks and my policy remains what it's always
been.
I'll
give
debate
a shit
anyone,
what you have to
anytime,
say.
Anywhere.
Stop complaining. You know,
Republican
do me a favor,
Hillary.
Set up a stage, put podiums up there, and let's just go.
Don't you mean donuts? Is that what you meant to say? Put donuts up there and let's go.
Podiums, donuts, same difference.
Podonuts, I mean podium donuts.
Podonuts.
Could I get a podium filled with donuts, please? Yeah, let's do it. I'm from New Jersey. Fuck the faggots. Ugh.
Well, just days ago, over 100 protesters gathered outside of the CDC right here in Atlanta.
Over 100,
transparency
huh?
When it comes to vaccines. So are these people conspiracy theorists, or did
yes.
They have a good reason to be here?
No.
I promise, this is a reality check you won't see anywhere else.
Reality check.
There's too much corruption.
Every time you hear these vaccine idiots, they come out to protest or they complain. It's like, there's not enough research on this, and we might be giving kids autism. It's like, well, you know what? I'd rather my kid be fucking alive and fucking have autism than dead.
Maybe they have autism.
You know, or you get that too. My you know, my cousin. Remember, we got people on the show that like, you know, my like, you know, my little brother got vaccines and then he got autism. So, you know, we know they cause it. It's like, no, you fucking don't.
Too much conflict of interest, and our children are paying the price.
Well, it is
how?
An incredibly
how are they paying
controversial
the price?
Subject to say the least.
Shh,
but
Scotty,
those protesters outside the CDC here in Atlanta
I
say that the information being provided to the public about vaccines is not completely honest. And all of it hinges on one man, this guy right here, a scientist you've probably never heard of. That scientist's name is Dr. William Thompson.
I hate him! He's an evil man.
And it was on August 27th of 2014 that Dr. Thompson made an admission that got very little media coverage, but it was a major statement. That statement read in part, quote, "I regret that my co-authors and I omitted statistically significant information in our 2004 article published in the journal Pediatrics. The omitted data suggested that African American males who received the MMR vaccine before age 36 months were at increased risk for autism."
Oh shit, Scotty. What now?
This guy's got the scoop.
One study, according to this guy who was part of it, and he said that they admitted data. Okay, if that's true, then that is a huge ethics violation, but this has been studied. This is the first study on the MMR vaccine to come back and have no and show no correlation. I mean, unless they can just demonstrate this time and time again, I don't think this conversation really needs to be had. I mean, in one time, I guess you could say that maybe there is a conspiracy, but he's talking about one study he was involved with. I don't know if this is like a huge a meta-analysis. I don't know what that it is, but it seems to me like he's talking about a particular study where he thinks there was a connection.
Plus, it says only black people, so, you know.
Don't even start. All right.
That's so racist of the MMR vaccine, too.
Decisions were made regarding the findings of the report at the data was collected, and I believe that the final study protocol was not
followed. It's a serious allegation.
So I'll tell you the significance of that statement in just a minute, but let's be clear here. Dr. Thompson did not come forward on his own. He released that statement I read to you only after he was secretly recorded by Dr. Brian Hooker. Now, once that happened, Thompson hired a whistleblower attorney, then turned over
Ben Swan, cracking the code.
This guy's bringing us the fucking hard-hitting truth that we can't get elsewhere.
Documents to Congress.
Reality check.
Dr. Thompson still works, by the way, for the CDC. And a few weeks ago, I requested a sit-down interview with him. Dr. Thompson refused that request.
That piece of shit!
What?
Boo!
Dr. Thompson, you coward!
You're a coward, Dr. Thompson! You're a coward!
Though he wouldn't sit down with me, Thompson has claimed that he's handed over documents about this case to Congressman Bill Posey's office.
Posey.
Now, I spoke with the congressman's office about that, and the spokesman confirms to me that thousands of documents were handed over, but sources within that office tell me as many as 100,000 documents were actually handed over. Congressman Posey brought this information to the floor of Congress, and what he read there was nothing short of stunning. That authors of the study not only hid the actual findings,
is this actually on like network news? This is insane.
It is.
Yeah, this is like, this sounds like a lot of much ado about like, nothing. It's
this
like
this is like local like network news, like you know like CBS News Columbus. Like that kind of shit.
And I mean, this guy is making an allegation that we don't know if it's true or not. And like I said, there's time and time again this thing's been studied and not come to this conclusion. I mean, hey, it's possible. It's very possible that it could be the case. But I mean, I don't really see a mound of evidence on their side. I mean, I guess they could say, oh, it's all being suppressed.
All these tests are being suppressed, and this guy's the only whistleblower that has the courage.
You would have to believe in a massive conspiracy, then.
And they do.
And I mean, that's not to immediately dismiss it, but I do not see any evidence to change my mind based upon this.
We're stupid, then.
Destroy evidence. Quoting from Dr. Thompson, the authors of the study decided not to disclose to the public that African-American boys under 36 months were more susceptible to developing autism or autism-like symptoms from the MMR vaccine.
Shit.
The remaining four co-authors all met and brought a big garbage can into the meeting room and reviewed and went through all the hard copy documents that we had thought we should discard and put them in a huge garbage can. However, because I assumed it was illegal and would violate both FOIA and DOJ requests, I kept hard copies of all documents in my office and I retained all associated computer files. I believe we intentionally withheld controversial findings from the final draft of the pediatrics paper.
So just...
Why would scientists intentionally hide controversial findings? I mean, you think they'd want more attention to their study.
Yeah, you think they would want to study this more. I mean, is there in fact a connection? I mean, if that's something that should be looked into. But I don't really get this whole, we had the big garbage can, it's like, we're going to burn this shit. You know, we don't want the public to know the truth. I mean, I'm extremely skeptical of that claim.
Thanks, Ben Swan.
Hey, Scotty, you've just garbage. Been reality checked, bitch.
With Ben Swan.
Ben Swan done reality checked your ass. Vaccines cause autism. If the conclusively people, proven.
If the people making those claims were really just like, we need more study and stuff like that, and that was their thing where it's like, we don't know and we want to know, I could understand that position. I don't understand the position of, we've declared it's bad, it's being suppressed, and we have evidence to prove 100% it's suppressed. Like, that one guy's allegations do not prove something.
Dr. William Thompson, Scotty, has proven 100%
he has not proven
that
anything.
Vaccines cause the autism.
He's made some allegations, and obviously they should be looked into and see if they have any merit.
In case you missed it there, Dr. Thompson, that statement, by the way, read into...
Just in case I missed it? What do you think, we're fucking retarded? I guess a lot of your viewers are probably really old.
Yeah, Ben Swan.
A CDC scientist and an author of a study in the journal Pediatrics.
Drew Ben.
Someone said Scotty must have gotten a vaccine. He looks autistic.
That's very offensive to autistic people. I demand that person apologize immediately to all autistic people.
Yeah.
That insisted there is no link between vaccines and autism. Admits that he and other authors of that study left out information that was deemed controversial. Information that in some African-American male children who are given the MMR vaccine...
What is the increase of this risk?
They said 36%.
I mean...
That's pretty significant.
That's significant, sure.
Why is it only African-American
children? I don't know.
Okay.
Who knows?
Measles vaccine before 36 months did have an increased risk of autism and signs of autism. And that not only did the CDC hide that information, but that the authors of the study threw that evidence into a trash can and destroyed it.
Those
so what you need to
shit.
Know here is that there is there so evidence much hysteria over this subject.
I mean, right now, this whole story has been based upon one person saying this happened and that someone was recorded. I mean, I would like to know more information. You know, before I would really cast judgment. I mean, if that did in fact happen, then that's wrong. They should not have done it. But I mean, I don't see any clear evidence that that's the standard we're holding it to. I think it's more analogous.
Someone said Ben Swan has Asperger's.
He does, dude. Look at him.
I hope so.
That's why he's so invested in this story. He's like, this might be the smoking gun.
Actually, you know what?
Life.
No, he doesn't deserve that. He deserves mad cow disease.
Munching on the prions, baby.
Why is it that you have to be all for vaccines given in all quantities at all times to all people, or you're anti-vaccination?
That's a good question.
Vaccines have saved more lives on this planet than any other single medical advancement. You might know that. But what you might not know is that all vaccines in all quantities for all people are not safe. Every year, hundreds of children are injured by vaccines here in the United States.
And there's courts set up to deal with
that.
Since
1986, the United States government, they have paid out $3 billion to the Vaccine Injury Compensation Program.
Yeah, but that's not for autism, though.
Yeah, those are people who have severe side effects, like, you know, the encephalitis or something, you know, or they stop breathing or they develop pneumonia or whatever.
But raise even one question, just one, about why that is, and you get shouted down. That's Reality Check. Let's talk about that tonight on Twitter.
All right.
Tweet this motherfucker.
Tweet Ben Swanson. Let him know. Does this have his address anywhere?
You get shouted
it's Ben
down.
Swan, not Swanson.
Was it not Swanson?
So you know that it's that typical
Swan.
Shit. We just asked a few questions and we were shouted down.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone would deny
Shut
that.
Shut up, Scotty.
No one's going to deny.
Shut up.
No one's going to deny.
Shut your fucking mouth.
The vaccines have harmed people.
Here's
killed them.
Stupid
Scotty.
Piece of shit.
Scotty, there was an E. coli scare at Chipotle.
Oh no. My go-to
restaurant.
An E. coli
scare causing Chipotle to temporarily close dozens of stores.
No,
no one has died in the nearly two dozen
sure
reported cases
by the
in Washington State and in Oregon.
Not
but the source of contamination is still unknown. Christina Alessi joins me now with more on this.
I'm going to go with beef.
This is scary.
Yes, this is very scary because we don't know
is
the source
really
yet.
Scary? It's not really scary.
Yeah, I'm not really scared. I don't
I'm
give a
scared.
Shit.
I'm not scared. I just ate at Chipotle a few days ago and I'm still not scared.
Well, you could be dead now.
As with what you would typically expect with these outbreaks, it takes a while for investigators to get to the bottom of it. One thing is for sure, it either came from the meat or the vegetables and the...
You know, hey, sure, it's possible it's from the vegetables, but come on. Every time this happens...
But I mean, like, that's everything they serve. It either came from the meat or the vegetables.
I guess it couldn't be the rice. Or the
no fucking shit.
Or the beans, maybe. Maybe they've eliminated those.
Okay, so they've eliminated rice and beans, but it's either the meat or the vegetables. Wow, really fucking.
If it's not, if it's not the beef, I would be amazed because they just had a huge.
Why do you always blame the beef, Scotty?
Well, they just had another huge recall. It's in the news right now. They've recalled a bunch of ground beef for the same exact reason as.
Okay.
You know.
I guess it is good.
Just go look it up. I mean, it's not some conspiracy thing. Just look up E. coli, you know, outbreaks, and you'll see it time and time again. Ground beef being recalled.
Oh, E. coli is good for you, Scotty, in small doses.
Well, yeah, certain kinds of E. coli are fine.
Oh, are they?
Yeah, it's present in your body. Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Good to know.
The government does keep track of a deadly strain of E. coli, and data shows that it is connected to either raw, or undercooked ingredients. Now, most restaurants have learned...
Sorry, raw foodists.
...how to cook meat so that you reduce the possibility of contaminated meat getting out. Now, one thing here, particular in this case, is that Chipotle really prides itself in fresh ingredients, right? You go to the store and you get your tomato, your lettuce, your guacamole, all of that is uncooked. So you increase the likelihood that a pathogen is in that quote-unquote fresh ingredient.
Why quote unquote?
Fresh.
Quote unquote fresh. It's fresh.
If it wasn't
it's
frozen.
That's what they're saying. Yeah, it's fresh. It's just fresh.
I like this thing here. Well, you can cook meat all the way. It's like it doesn't matter. There's plenty of times there's meat that's already been cooked that people still get sick from.
Shut up.
And if it's a steak, a lot of the steak there is cooked like medium, you know, to medium rare. So.
And that's about as much as it should ever be cooked.
Yeah, I agree with you on that.
I like how TJ doesn't. Okay, so there's this hibachi restaurant that we go to, and Scotty ate there once and got sick.
Yeah, really sick.
But TJ doesn't believe that Scotty got sick the food.
I know I did.
No.
Okay, well, I guess I don't know I did, but I'm pretty sure.
Because none of us got sick while we were eating.
But I realized I got a different dish than everyone else.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Other people caught it, too. So, I mean, it was obviously something contagious. You probably just got it from another person.
Well, then someone at the restaurant gave me it.
Well, you don't know that.
You know, so I think they improperly handled my food or something. So, I was ill. And
probably just saw you and decided to jizz on your fucking food.
You know what? Maybe that's what happened. But it's still the fact still remains.
Oh,
I was
sick. This special sauce for you.
Special sauce.
Which it is fresh. Chipotle's trying to do the right thing here, but there is an increased likelihood. Now, also keep in mind that the industry has no way of really keeping track of pathogens in our food. It's not like they're testing routinely whether or not these foods contain salmonella, listeria. The only way we find out is after people get sick.
So I would suppose they're interviewing the people who've gotten sick to see if they ate similar items, right? That's the way they track it down.
Right, and Chipotle.
Okay, well, Chipotle, pretty much everyone's eating similar items. I mean, it's a pretty small menu. There's, like, some key ingredients, and that's about it.
This is just more fear-mongering fucking bullshit.
Be afraid!
You know, you hear it all the time on the news, and it's a narrative they want to craft. It's like, they're not testing enough, they're not doing this enough, and it's like, you wonder why that we don't fucking have everything just down to a gnat's ass in life, because a lot of times when shit does what just works, we don't want to fucking see, oh, could it work better? Maybe sometimes, but, like, if for the most part this hasn't happened at Chipotle, it doesn't really seem like an issue. If it continuously happens, then yeah, it's like, we need to find a better way. But I mean, one time, I don't really know. I mean, it only happened to 43 of the locations.
Yeah, I mean, like, plenty of restaurants have had these sorts of scares before. I remember Taco Bell had one probably like 15, 20 years back.
Oh, sooner that you're talking about the lettuce or something at Taco Bell or something like that.
Yeah, I think it was the lettuce.
Was it the lettuce or the tomatoes?
I think it was one of the.
I think it was like actually both happened at Taco Bell or something. But yeah, plenty of restaurants have had these kind of scares. And, you know, part of it with the meat is just like the way the meat is, you know, the factory farm meat comes out to you and how sick the animals are. And they don't live in the greatest conditions. We all know it. So, I mean.
Yeah, those fucking tomatoes and lettuce at Taco Bell, they just were mistreating them and stuff.
Well, I know. That's probably.
They were sickly.
They were probably grown in Mexico and probably came across contaminants like, you know, feces and sewage and stuff like that.
To your point is being very cautious because it's not only shutting down those six stores that are linked to sick patients, but it's taken the precaution of shutting down all the stores in those two states because presumably they're using.
All right.
Seems pretty logical.
I feel like moving on.
Yeah.
I say a trip to Uruguay is in order. And I will show
they
you.
They do it.
And I will show
don't
you
they have
why.
Legal weed?
Uruguay has set the price of marijuana at $1.40 per gram.
All right,
the first
book my flight.
To legalize pot is aiming to produce between 6 and 10 tons
like,
a year for local use. Almost everything
I guess
is
George
set
R. R.
to
Martin is there, so
$1.30.
That's what I loved about the Netherlands. Not that weed was like this cheap, because I mean it wasn't.
No, it's way cheaper.
Even though you know what. At the hostel I stayed at, like someone left a bunch of weed behind, and it was just like, wow, someone left like 5 grams of weed.
Yep.
To go here's your on free sale. Weed, sir. Put weed on your pillow.
That would be awesome.
It isn't the state's goal to do business, because really, the logic of this business is that it will decrease, but while it exists, there will be an income for the state. Because there will be a 10 to 13 state fee from the price of $1.20 or $1.40 in addition.
What a radical idea. Hey, everyone's doing this thing. Let's just take it out from the black market, make money for the government, and they'll continue to do it, and it's not a big deal anymore.
I don't like that sort of communistic approach.
Yeah, I know. Like, how flawed is their thinking?
To what the business will have to pay for the license. Yeah.
I think that's it.
Yeah, so I just thought that was interesting.
There's something about boycotting Quentin Tarantino's new movie.
Yeah, I have that on.
I'll be seeing it, so I don't really give a shit.
Why do people want to boycott
it? He marched in some protest. I think it was like a Black Lives Matter
News
thing or something.
But it's kind of dumb.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
They don't like his movies to begin with, so any excuse for him to be shit on by them is not a much of a surprise.
So here's a video where a CNN anchor talks shit about the bitches on The View.
Sweet.
Yeah.
The View is a terrible
this.
Show.
Sometimes you gotta call it like you see it. And I saw something today
I like Whoopi, though.
That angered me. Not just as a journalist, but as a woman.
I remember that time she was fucking in that movie with that dinosaur and shit. That was pretty horrible.
Yeah, and a defender of Bill Cosby, TJ.
Yeah, she fucking...
And Mel Gibson.
Yeah, and Mel Gibson, so...
You know she's got some dark shit going on when she's defending those guys, like...
She defends a rapist and an anti-Semite.
Maybe she'll just defend anyone.
We're going to have the most speaking time, yeah. Then followed by Rubio, Kasich,
but I
Trump.
The one thing she said, that's the beauty of it.
What did she say? What did she say?
You know what Carly said, which really made
three
me laugh?
Pages.
Three pages.
So I've not gleaned anything so far.
So this is just basically women talk at each other, the show, and it's just like, another thing. It's like, why would you want to fucking watch this shit? This is horrible.
I mean, I'm sure our show has sounded pretty similar at times. So.
Yes.
But not nonstop.
But not as estrogeny.
Kicked off, I don't know what's happening. She kicked off her thing saying, you know, people tell me that I didn't smile enough during the last debate. She looked demented. I mean, she did not, her mouth did not downturn one time. She was like,
Halloween mask. I love that.
Smiling Fiorina. Can you imagine?
I think demented is a strong word, but it looked like she'd been practicing that for a long time. And she did get some affirmation from Trump.
She means demented.
So Carly Fiorina smiled too much.
Yeah.
As a comic, I have to stand up for the words we use.
Demented? Her face could be a Halloween mask? Listen, I love The View. I have been a longtime Whoopi fan. I think Joy Behar is one of the funniest people on TV.
I like Whoopi because of Star Trek.
Come on. Double standard much? Guinan. First, people jump on Trump for his comments in Rolling Stone about Fiorina's face. He followed up at the debate saying she was beautiful. Which, by the way, a lot of ladies didn't like either. Why do we have to talk about her looks? Because she's a woman? All this yapping about
talk
women
about
and appearance,
looks.
And then The View today.
Every candidate is totally scrutinized in every way.
Yeah.
Saying is, we women can be the worst to one another. We say, don't talk about their looks. Look what happens. I know these ladies on The View.
It's a fucking show
so
for entertainment
value.
What do you fucking expect? Yeah. Like, you really expect this show, like, what are they going to do about every person they talk about? Just love everybody. Have no problems with any person. What do you want these fucking people to say?
All they're doing is making fun of the fact that she smiled too much and looked demented.
Yeah, she's a fucking phony. What the fuck do you want? No, you need to respect her. It's
why? What's all this? We need to give artificial respect to Carly Fiorina.
Well, fuck her. She could earn some fucking respect. If he's not gonna,
I don't give a fuck about her.
I love this artificial. You need to say yes, sir, and yes, ma'am, and do all this shit. Like, fuck that shit.
Fuck it. Fuck it in the ass.
We all signed up for, but still... We can do better than that. And how do I know this? How do I know I'm not alone?
You're reading off a teleprompter.
To follow up on that, now don't hang up when I do this. Because you talked about Carla Fiorina in Rolling Stone magazine, and you said, look at that face. Would anyone vote for that? Can you imagine that, the face of our next president? Are you making fun of her looks, Donald? Because I know you don't like it.
No, I'm talking about the persona.
Okay, so that is a bit hypocritical then. Because they're basically on Donald Trump's case for doing the same thing they were just doing.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, I have to agree with the anchor now in light of that.
Yeah, when you hear that part of it, you're like, oh, wow, they're fucking morons.
I'm talking about her persona. She failed miserably at Hewlett-Packard. She failed at Lucent. She was, before that, she was at Lucent. She then ran for the Senate. She lost in a landslide. Right. Now she's running for president. I'm talking about...
He sounds like the voice of God as loud as he is compared to them.
Her persona.
You know, they've actually done studies, and they said it's, you know what, they compared substance and, you know, all these different things and measures about the public speaking, and they found one of the most important things is just how quickly you speak, because you can just get more out, so people don't have as much time to actually think about what you're saying. So Trump or these other people, you notice that are really good politicians, are usually really smooth talkers, and they can just go on and on and on.
But then explain Ben Carson, who talks like a fucking turtle.
Well, that's just, obviously his supporters are just a bunch of sycophant fucking Christian idiots. They're just like, I'm voting for him because he's a good Christian.
He's a Christian.
You know, you gotta fucking, some of these people just roll out religion. Like, I just love religion. Me and religion, me and the Bible, we best friends.
Plus, he's even darker than Obama, so it's more progressive in a way.
Talk about her brain instead of her face.
Yeah, you didn't do it, so fuck you. Anyway.
All right, let's do John Kasich.
Oh, gross.
Governor, a lot of people thought you had a strong
Gary Shandling.
Debate last night.
Oh,
there was the exchange you had with Donald Trump. I'm wondering what changed in your calculus of how to deal with him? Because for a long time, you indicated you didn't really want to engage with him. You didn't want to go that route. And then there was an exchange last night.
Well, Anderson, it really wasn't just aimed at Donald Trump. I mean, I just reached a tipping point when I hear people talk about eliminating Medicaid and Medicare and replacing it with something, and I hear another guy talk about deporting 10 or 11 people. I've been thinking about that for a long time. And then these tax schemes, which, and I'm for tax cutting, but tax schemes are going to put us trillions of dollars in debt and put more debt on my kids. At some point, I had to speak out, and I just sort of reached the tipping point. And
What tipping point did he reach? Because I have not watched this debate yet.
Okay, the tipping point he reached
was
he's like, you know what?
So he got pissed?
Yeah, a little. I mean, in a very controlled manner.
Look, people like fucking... People watch these debates because they want to see him fucking argue.
It's I want to see...
That's what a debate is about. No one wants to see the debate. Well, I respect you. Well, you know what? I respect you as well.
I want them to go...
They don't
want
them
to enter Thunderdome.
Two men enter, one man leave. In this
That's
case, it'd
be
like 20 men enter.
Like Klingons. That's how Klingons.
So basically,
the
Republicans
chancellor.
And the fucking Democrats just all fight it out, and then the last two, the top Republican, top Democrat, just go and fight it out, and for 4 years they.
How about
agree.
Everyone but Bernie Sanders just goes and fights to the death, and then we can't crown him president afterwards.
Sounds good. You know what? I'm behind that.
All right.
Are personal. They're really my deep concern about us picking somebody who doesn't know how to do the job or making too many promises, like a chicken in every pot. Now I have a program. That will cut taxes. It will.
Chicken on in every pot is a pretty low fucking standard, man.
Demagoguery works. That's why they fucking Trump and these other people do it. I mean, come on. It's like telling people what they want to hear. What a novel fucking idea, you know? Come on. It's just that's fucking rule one of politics. Because you have to tell someone what they want to hear.
Balance the budget. That will do a lot of things to create jobs, but the numbers fit together. It's not some made up fantasy plan.
Oh, man, there's no rampage.
He ran by double digits, or he won by double digits in his last election.
Yeah.
It's pretty crazy.
He ain't winning this one, I don't think, anyway.
All right, the GOP refuses to work with NBC anymore after the last debate.
Okay.
Due to gotcha questions.
Fucking gotcha.
Gotcha.
For Republican politicians, claims of media bias are both a shield and a sword.
Oh, wow.
To a lot of people in the media,
media,
this is just
never
a great big game,
before.
And we're the players. And we come out here and we do our thing. And sometimes we're held up in contempt by people who write columns.
It's a way to deflect tough, unwelcome questions. And it's a way to show strength, putting the press on the defensive.
How do we decide who gets to follow up? I've seen 20 other people follow up.
It was at the moderator discretion.
On CNBC's stage, Rand Paul, Marco Rubio, Ted Cruz, and others showed just how effective media bashing can be.
The Democrats have the ultimate super PAC. It's called the mainstream media. Who every single day...
This is something they always run to is the liberal media.
The media makes it seem like we're a bunch of morons, but in actuality, well, I guess we are, but they make it seem like it too, that's not fair.
That's not fair to make us look so bad and so stupid and so wrong about so many issues, like pretty much everything.
This has been a staple of Republican politics since the 1960s.
Media attacks are easy applause lines in front of conservative audiences.
She says that you came to her in 1999 at a time when you were having an affair. She says you asked her, sir, to enter into an open marriage. Would you like to take some time to respond to that?
No, but I will. And I am frankly astounded that CNN would take trash like that and use it to open a presidential debate.
Now, most journalists will tell you they try very hard to expunge any and all bias from their stories. But many conservatives laugh at that.
Most of the people in my business are convinced that you are biased against all of us.
I can spot those liberal media folk here to write their annual Conservatives in Crisis story.
It kind of goes without saying that there is definitely a media...
Okay, you got 12 million people.
A bunch of fucking persecuted little whiny babies. Like, this guy is a fucking politician. He's won elections on his little bullshit. And, you know, it's like, poor me. People are mean to me. People scrutinize what I do.
It's because in America, everyone gets a victim card. And everyone gets to play it all the time. And everyone gets to say they're persecuted. And everyone gets to say that they're victimized. And everyone gets to say that, you know, just... They're the ones who are being treated unfairly and all this other shit. And it's 99% of the time bullshit.
You know, but TJ, I really want to say that I am definitely persecuted.
These Republicans are bitching about the media the same way that Tumblrettes bitch about the rest of the internet.
I am persecuted, TJ. Shut up. You don't even understand my plight.
Shut up.
Fucking privileged piece of shit.
The result? More political polarization. According to Pew, the more conservative you are, the fewer mainstream media sources you trust. Fox News has benefited from that. And so have some candidates.
Fox News is mainstream media.
Not conservative enough for me. I just go to Alex Jones, InfoWar.
That's not conservative enough for me. I go to WorldNet Daily.
Ain't owned by some big corporation, so you know you can trust it.
I think it's called WorldNet Daily. It's crazy.
Several of them declared war on the liberal media, emailing supporters asking for money while mocking the moderators. And they're not the only ones doing that.
It just seemed that they lost their way and that they did not seem to be in command of it.
The RNC, which picked CNBC for the debate, put the media on notice, saying bias won't be tolerated. But were CNBC's questions really any tougher than Fox's?
Everyone's fucking biased. That makes no sense.
Some of the criticism is for show. What those moderators at CNBC were trying to do was to get candidates to tell more of the truth.
Fucking journalists trying to get fucking candidates to answer questions they don't want to. Pieces of shit.
We just want the candidates to be honest. And the candidates are like, this isn't fair. That's essentially what the story breaks down to. It's
how
like,
dare you ask me that question?
It's unfair that they have to tell the truth. So that's American politics in a nutshell.
Sheriff David Clark says police brutality doesn't exist on Fox News.
Oh, of course.
It doesn't.
All of them should be held responsible because the police officers, the good ones, as they say, they don't testify against them.
That's
so
true.
Nope. Because you want to know what happens?
You want to know what happens? I've watched so many things about this, and it's like, you know, there was a guy in a prison thing, and like the cops like basically assaulted this guy. We're just beating the shit. I think they actually like, beat the, like his eye out of his head, and you know, it almost died. And the guy came forward and was like, you know, these other cops did this, and the other cops were fired and everything else, and, you know, went to jail. I think two of them went to prison. He was like, he was pretty much just fired after that. He was just treated like shit. He was an outcast, and he said, like, this is a hostile work environment. I can't be here anymore. No other cops want me around, trust me, or they basically, they're gunning for me.
Yeah, because they consider it, they have that, you know, whole blue code and shit, and anyone who fucking actually testifies against other police is a rat. And, you know, they've betrayed the brotherhood of cops and all this bullshit.
It's funny when you look at criminals and you look at the police and see how similar they really are.
Well, similar? They're the fucking same. The only difference is our tax dollars pay for one of them. Fuck the police.
Coming straight from
you need
brown.
To quit your job.
Wow, a slap in the face to law enforcement just days after an NYPD...
They deserve a lot more than a slap in the fucking face. Fucking pig, fucking pieces of shit.
D cop was killed in cold blood, who, by the way, was African American. Hundreds descending upon the street to mid.
Oh, well, then he's okay.
Town Manhattan to march against cops and even chant expletives for those who protect and serve.
Okay, so I get it now. So basically,
too.
This cop was
here
killed.
Now discuss-
and now, and they're pissed off that people are protesting.
And
you
now
know,
this guy's
going
to offer his little Nazi
Look,
opinion.
You know what? Look, no one's fucking sharing this cop was killed. Like, I think if you value human life, you're not happy when anyone is murdered or killed or bad things happen to them. But these people have a right to protest, and you know, if this probably happened or not, they planned this. I'm sure they didn't just plan this event because of this. They probably planned the event a while ago, got permits, and marched. Who cares? It's their right.
This guy cares. Look at him.
Well, he's an asshole then.
They oh, we've had that this guy on
yeah,
before.
Yeah, I remember.
Yeah, this guy's an asshole.
He needs to replace that American flag lapel with the SS symbol.
Where we go from here, Fox News contributor and former homicide detective Rod Wheeler, who was out and got those sound bites for us and did all those interviews, and Milwaukee County Sheriff David Clark. Since we spoke
Fuck
to you,
you
Rod
David
earlier,
Clark.
Let's get the sheriff to weigh in. Sheriff, your reaction to some of the sentiment you heard on the streets.
Anyone who wears an American flag lapel pin is a piece of shit. Just going to put it out there.
On Saturday.
Well, it's just crazy talk. That's ignorance in its purest form.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think we need to rethink this strategy. I don't know why the police even bother policing those demonstrations. They're not protests. Those people advocate for the overthrow of our legally constituted government.
Hey, the president
would do
says they have a point,
let them
Sheriff.
Fend for them. Let
yeah,
them
stop
fend,
killing
let
black
them
people. That equates to overthrowing the government now. Don't kill this group of our citizens, which are disproportionately killed by the police. Same as overthrow of the government.
White guilt.
Is it
Scotty?
White
guilt.
I've said it before. If someone who's black pointed a gun at a cop and was killed, I'm not shedding any tears for him. But people who are unarmed,
racist.
People who are unarmed and killed by the police, regardless of their race, should not be killed by the police, especially when they're unarmed and generally not hurting or much of a threat to the you know, police officers there. I mean, so.
Yeah, look at these violent people trying to overthrow the government here. Look at them, man. They look like such a threat to the government, don't they?
Oh, yeah, it's so terrifying.
We just need to round these people up and gas them.
For themselves, but
the
good
police are mad they're being held accountable.
New York clash with them for disrupting their lives, disrupting their businesses. Then the police can show up and arrest these subhuman creeps.
Subhumans, everybody. Look at all these subhumans
so,
on the screen.
When people exercise their constitutional rights to peacefully assemble, you're against it, and you want...
So here's a guy...
You want the fucking Gestapo to come in and fucking crack down.
Speaks volumes about how cops feel...
I don't hear you in my headsets.
Oh, I was going to say, this speaks volumes about how cops feel about citizens.
Right,
oh,
yeah. I mean, here's a guy who's basically taking people who are obviously having a peaceful protest and saying they're subhumans. This is a guy who's currently in law enforcement in a position of power. He doesn't have any interest in upholding the rights of the citizenry. He only has power in protecting his fucking institution, the institution of the police. They're a fucking gang. They're a cartel. They're a mafia. That's all the fuck they are.
They're legally authorized.
Fuck them in the ass until dead. Thank you very much.
Tell us how you really feel, TJ.
For creating a disturbance.
Fuck the police.
That we can do.
Now, Rod, do you have a different sense? You're actually on the street talking to them. Number one, did the cops play an important role in keeping them safe? And you tell me about the sentiment you heard.
They did, Brian. I mean, the cops were out there. You know, I must say that the police were taking a lot of verbal abuse while they were out there, and it was really unfortunate. But I also must say that the police did not turn their backs on the citizens, and even the people that had the biggest smiles out there, the folks that I was talking to.
So the police, you had to endure verbal, like, harassment. Okay, would you prefer that people are going fuck the police than pulling out guns and shooting at cops? I think it's basically much easier and much better to just insult somebody. And obviously they're against you and they're against the institution that you represent. But if they're doing it peacefully, then what's the fucking big deal?
If they were to call those police officers today, those same police officers would still be there to assist them. Look, Brian, it was just last week when a young New York police officer was gunned down in cold blood right here in this city where I'm at now. And you know what? This officer hasn't even been eulogized yet, and these people are out there talking about deaths to cops. So I think it's ridiculous, and I wish that the...
I did not see a single sign that said death to cops.
And if someone said that, I'd just be like, well, you're an ignorant asshole.
Well, death to cops, but...
You're an ignorant asshole.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't want...
Politicians I don't want people to speak up killed. A little bit more, because actually, you know what I think? I think a lot...
Not people, just cops.
Oh, come on.
Protesters get their energy...
Hey, they can see pseudo-speciate, so can I.
From some of these liberal politicians.
That's well, I'm not, you can't say that's representative of every cop, but obviously he doesn't represent a portion of them.
Standing up because this has been a
reminds me of every cop
has
I ever
not
met.
Been righted yet. Your right. reaction?
But you know what, though, Brian? A lot of the people I talk to, I'm sorry, Sheriff, a lot of the people that I talk to, they were saying that their frustration,
Sheriff,
believe it or
bitch.
Not, is with
Shut
the government,
up.
And they specifically said, Brian, President Obama.
Well, Sheriff, go ahead.
Well, first of all, there is no police brutality in America. We ended it.
There's mountains of video evidence to the contrary.
Yeah, we've shown most of it on this show.
It is 100% guaranteed that there is a lot of police brutality in America and police overreach in our lives. Anyone that says otherwise is a fucking total moron who is not at all up to speed on current events.
Let me just ask you a question then, Scotty. If like tomorrow someone gunned this guy down and he's dead, are you really going to be sad?
I'm not going to be sad, but I don't think it should have happened.
Well, that's a different question.
That's my answer.
I guess you did answer the question, though, so.
Back in the 60s, so I don't know where they're coming from. You look at the data and the research, and there's a new Harvard study out that shows that there is no racism in the hearts of police officers. They go about their daily duty, if you will, to keep communities safe. The President of the United States knows better. He's playing the race game. He's playing race politics. Shame on him. He's been very divisive for this country. He has been a nightmare, and I cannot wait.
What has Obama done exactly to cause this
race
division?
War?
Yeah, race war time.
You know, I seem to recall that there was a series of events that Obama pretty much had nothing to do with, and then Obama came out and condemned them. So, at what point did Obama condone anything like this?
Also, if this happened one time, if once every 10 years this happened, and these people are out in the street doing this, I think we would all say, these people really don't know what they're talking about. This is a very rare occurrence, and it seems like in most cases, you can understand why this occurred. This happens all the time. I'm not going to say it's the most common crime, or a common thing to occur, but it happens all the time. So what this guy is saying is that all these people are just out here for no reason. They're just a bunch of conspiracy theorist nuts, like Alex Jones wannabes, who are just out here, you know, to start a race war, to cause controversy. And that's just ridiculous.
It seems like a pretty heavily multiracial crowd to me, so it's a pretty terrible race war that all these different races have gotten together to support.
Until January of 2017, so that America's nightmare can be over.
Black Lives Matter, does it play an important role? First, you, Sheriff?
No, it's garbage. It's a subversive movement. Like I said, they advocate the overthrow of our legally constituted government. Right. It is not a protest movement.
Rod?
I think, yes, it does matter. I think all lives matter, and I think what they're arguing about and protesting about is valid. It's just the way that they're going about doing it, I think, is totally misdirected. Right?
It isn't valid. Knock it off. You're contributing to the problem here. It is not valid. There is no research.
Someone nuanced position. Shut up, moron!
You's dumb.
Like, all lives matter.
Show me the research that demonstrates or supports that lie that law enforcement officers use an inordinate amount of force against black people.
Yeah, but
there's tons of research.
What?
Effect.
There's give me a break.
Literally tons. There's a shitload. It's like abundant out there.
If this guy has like any sort of social media presence, people should just send him just loads of information. Just like, here you go, moron.
Yeah,
fine. Just gonna leave this here.
Find Sheriff Retard and send him the statistics he wants. I promise you, they're easily found on Google. It won't even take you 2 minutes.
But Sheriff,
black people use an inordinate amount of force against themselves and each other in the American ghetto. It is not true about the American police officer, and I'm not going to let anybody.
Is Uncle Ruckus on the show now? I didn't realize that this was actually Uncle Ruckus.
Well, he doesn't have the lazy eye.
And advocate that.
Sheriff,
about all of
this. Sounds like him, though.
I don't have to be fair.
I don't have to be
fair. I don't have to be fair or logical.
Police officers are just go out and do things wrong to people, but there are some valid arguments that we both, on both
sides,
need to really take.
There are no valid arguments. There is no police brutality in the United States.
Sheriff
Retard. I need a little bell so I can be like, retard.
No. There's no evidence. There's no valid
Sheriff
arguments.
David Clark.
This guy is a nut.
I want you guys to send Sheriff David Clark lots of fucking information because it seems like he's been deprived of information he needs.
Yeah, that's Clark with an E at the end.
So send him some examples of police brutality. What about the guy that was gunned down as he was running away and then the taser was planted on him? Like, surely that is an instance of police brutality. I mean, are you really going to sit here and say there's no police brutality? None?
Fuck that guy.
And send him some of these statistics about how police do, in fact, treat black people unfairly. And, in fact, the entire legal system does.
All right, moving on.
Crazy people. Oh, shit. The manatee is back.
All right. Let's see. Which one should I do? You know what? 1 second here. There's something I wanted to play that I, for some reason, didn't put into the playlist.
Okay.
I'm gonna pull it up while we're waiting for Scotty to come back.
Ben is doing stuff.
I'm doing stuff.
Ben is doing stuff. So we're just gonna wait.
All right. Do you remember? I'm sure you remember him. Undertaker Freak.
Yeah.
Undertaker Freak made a video that he considers to be a sincere apology to you.
Neat.
That just recently, he just recently put out.
A real apology.
A real apology to you.
Sweet.
From who?
From Undertaker Freak.
What? That's...
Did this happen one time before, though?
I don't know.
Like, no, didn't he file, like, a privacy complaint against you? Then he's like, you talk to him, and he's like, oh, I guess you're
all
right.
No, I think that was Must Destroy All.
No, I think that was Undertaker
Freak.
I don't
know. Who cares? Just watch the fucking video.
Oh, you're garbage.
Contrary to
wow, he still has
you
that.
May believe, based on some other apology videos that I've made in the past on this channel, I am capable of admitting genuine, sincere wrongdoing on this channel. I have done it.
Secret Canadian.
So put all of those other apology, you know, the apology to Sean's viewing tape.
No, he's not a
Secret Canadian.
No. He's a Michigander. Worse.
Oh, God. I didn't realize. I do retract that statement.
If this is a sincere apology, I want you to send me your Goomba hoodie thing.
Oh, whatever. That doesn't apologize.
Oh, man. Fuck you, TJ. You fucking agree. What is your obsession with other people's hats?
I don't know.
Before we get into this, you literally just like see someone's hat. You're like, I want that hat. I want to buy it. I want to rip it off their head.
An apology to
I'm
an easy on apology
person.
To this guy, that
yes,
guy.
You
put,
are.
Put all of those satirical and facetious videos out of your mind.
Okay.
Those ones were satirical and facetious. This one, however, is 100% genuine.
Okay.
And if it's not, you can just think of something very horrible that you want to do to me, and I will allow you to do it to me. Within
right.
reason.
That's a bad idea
okay.
for TJ.
I don't want things being placed in my rectum. Or let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Sorry, TJ.
But we won't.
How about urethra? You want to do some sandwiching or something, you know?
Ow!
Man, TJ, you know, I don't know about you, man.
Yeah, you do.
Even have the opportunity to get ahead of ourselves because this is 100% he sincere. Does.
I
would like to publicly
apologize to the Amazing Atheist for something that I did a long...
Apology not accepted, bitch!
TJ's offended.
A long time ago. You see, this thing that I did to him, I hadn't really thought about it in a while, but somebody posted a comment in one of my videos saying that I was on the Drunken Peasants or something like that. It's a podcast that the Amazing Atheist and some other people I've never heard of in my life do.
Ooh,
what
diss.
The fuck, man?
Diss.
Undertaker freak. You know, you're apologizing to TJ, but then you're making new enemies.
You done been dissed.
Yeah, we haven't made it yet.
And I saw one of them about a year ago, and I posted a comment on it.
It was a ridiculously stupid
and,
comment.
And I guess the guy's comment made me think about the Amazing Atheist and made me think about what I did to him.
Oh, yeah.
Because two things are sort of in the same vein.
Oh, fuck yeah. Atheist.
And when I look back on this thing that I did, I'm just like, wow.
I want to eat your banana.
I'd really like to make amends for it. Because it really, really, really made me look like a dick. Even though I had a lot of support for what
ding,
I
ding,
did,
ding, 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 ding.
I also had a lot of detractors and a lot of antagonists. And the more I thought about it, the more I began to realize that these detractors and antagonists had very good points against me. I was so blinded by my hatred, my pure hate.
Let the hate flow through you.
This guy, that I did not take their opinions into account, and I did not take what they had to say into account. And one of the main points they were making against me was that I was being a petty douchebag. And
well, I mean, that's kind of been your MO.
Yeah, I mean,
since
I have
started. I mean,
I have watched some of his videos that I have enjoyed, but yes, in
I mean,
many
like,
of his videos, petty douchebag. Yes, I have. I'm not even
saying that's necessarily bad because I'm definitely a petty douchebag too.
Yeah,
but you know,
they're right. So I'm going to take this time, all these years later, to not only explain to you what happened, but to explain why I was wrong, and to apologize. Now, what happened, a few years back, the Amazing Atheist uploaded a video called, what was it? YouTube is Love, I believe it was. And it was a video in which he had a smattering of clips from people on YouTube talking shit about him.
Yep.
And he was being him and, you know, saying, oh, all these people hate me. And here's some clips. And he played a bunch of clips. And I made the cut. My video made the cut. One of my videos made the cut. Only it was a very small
clip of the
video.
Proudest moment
of
your life.
Cut off right before I made the points I was trying to make in the video. I didn't like that very much.
Oh, so he pulled a Jenny McDermott. Well,
yeah, that's what I was talking about.
You took me out of context.
So you filed a privacy complaint against TJ.
Oh my god, you fucking edited around my points and stuff.
If I was making a refutation video against you, maybe that would be a big deal, but I wasn't, so.
Mostly because I really hated the guy.
Oh, I can't blame
you. I didn't like a lot of the company that I was with in that video. And I didn't like the fact that many of the other videos were just people going, oh, yeah, this guy sucks, I hate him. But I felt that my video was actually well-crafted and had...
You were mistaken.
Yeah, of course you felt that way.
You know,
everyone feels that way about the shit they do for the most part.
Brett Keane feels that way.
Well, I mean, in his case, it's true. I mean, come on,
yeah,
Brett.
Yeah.
Brett is a fucking genius.
Yeah, man.
Had valid arguments and points toward the guy.
You know, I don't even like David Lynch, but I suddenly want David Lynch to direct a movie about Brett Keane's life.
So, I filed a privacy complaint against the video, and the video had to be amended. I think it got taken down, and he had to re-upload it, taking
my
video out of
piece
there.
Of
now,
shit.
I felt that I was completely justified for
you
those
weren't.
Reasons.
You're a piece of garbage.
But what I did was... It was really stupid, now that I think about it. Even then, I felt so justified. I felt like I was doing the right thing, because I was technically well within my rights to file a privacy complaint, because you can file a privacy complaint if you show up in someone's video publicly and you did not give them permission. But I felt so justified in doing what I did, but what I did was pretty monumental given the circumstances. I mean, The Amazing Atheist is a huge fucking YouTuber. He's a huge deal here on YouTube. He's in that upper,
he's garbage.
Upper crust, nah. If you will, in terms of subscribers and views and stuff barrel. Like that.
Well, this video's pretty boring.
And I had one of his videos taken down.
Is that like another shoe that drops or something?
For what I consider now to be completely bogus bullshit reasons. If I had a problem with it, if I had a problem with being in the video, all the problems, the aforementioned problems, I should have handled it a lot better. I shouldn't have filed a privacy complaint. I sure as hell should not have had the video taken down. That's not me, I don't think.
It is, though.
And it wasn't very rational. And I can't really think of anything right now that could excuse it. You know, I could tell you that I felt that I was being
misrepresented. I wonder if he's going to do another privacy complaint against this one.
Misrepresented. I could tell you that I felt that I didn't belong in that video or belong among many of the other people in there who were just saying, oh, I hate you because you suck.
And later on, he says someone did that to him.
Uh-huh.
Someone did to him what he did to you, and he got pissed off about it.
Yeah. Well, fuck him.
At least he's admitting that he was wrong.
Okay. Good for him. I knew he was wrong a long time ago. I'm glad he finally caught up. But you could take your apology and shove it up your ass, bitch. Because the Amazing Atheist has already forgot about you and doesn't give a fuck no more.
This is still on.
Yeah, it's still on.
Now that's victim blaming.
I wish Mario would come and stomp on his Goomba fucking head.
What's going on, guys?
Hey, Robert E. Lee.
And in today's video, I wanted to go through this one video I saw the other day.
Okay.
By TJ, the Amazing Atheist. I think this is actually one really good video to go through. I think particularly for a couple of reasons. I'll explain as the video continues. The first 9 minutes of this video in particular, I'm going to skip because it's about gun control and the UCC shooting. Now, the reason why I'm going to skip this is because I intend on doing another video, if I haven't done it already, another video on gun control and how asinine a lot of the people are when they talk about it and what the real solution to the problem is. That a lot of people say
the real solution
reasons? I don't know, probably because they're really difficult solutions, I guess. I don't know. You'll find out if my video making schedule might be out before now, later. I don't know. It's gonna skip all.
Who cares? Please explain more.
It's you probably have already heard everything he'd already said about gun control anyway.
Set. So, mm-hmm.
No real reason to go through it. You want to go through it, of course, by all means.
Get to the point, motherfucker.
No, today I'm going to go through the last, I'd say, about 5 minutes above his video and kind of chat about that, because it's very disturbing to me personally.
Cool.
For obvious reasons, as you will see. So, I'm going to do this all just the car style. Phone. Just listen. So hopefully this shit is loud enough. If not, I'll move it closer.
Okay.
The degradation of society.
Oh, yeah. So dramatic.
Now I have to get into another subject matter. I know that this makes no sense. It's supposed to be about gun control, but there is something else I'd like to talk about the UCC shooter that I don't want to make another video, so I'm just going to add it as an addendum to this video. There's a story going around, it's been published in several newspapers, and it's been stated by several eyewitnesses of the crime that Chris Harper Mercer targeted Christians when he went to his classroom. He said, all the Christians stand up, and systematically,
with a real Slim Shady, please stand up.
Shot him in the head. If they said they were not a Christian or they didn't answer him at all, he shot him in the leg.
Mm-hmm.
I hate to be a conspiracy theorist, but I have a lot of trouble buying this narrative. I just don't understand why the classroom would continue to cooperate with him for so long as this is happening, when it becomes evident that, yes, he's shooting everyone who's a Christian, and in fact, he's shooting everyone, at least in the leg. I mean, like, why was there no effort to escape or to attack?
Well, see, that's the...
Yeah, I shouldn't have put my personal incredulity up there so high. Because, you know, the more I actually thought about it, the more I thought of so many examples in human psychology where people are that passive when threatened with violence. And they will just kind of accept that, you know? Like when the Jews were being led into the gas chamber, you know, they outnumbered the Nazis leading them there significantly. Prisoners far outnumber guards in American prisons, and they're still passive, you know, for the most part.
Yeah.
So there does seem to be something in human psychology that just, like, when you're faced with a... Quit coughing, you motherfucking miserable sack of shit.
Oh, you're one to talk.
Yeah, you have no room to talk on the cough.
Man, he's been coughing nonstop for the last, like, few days.
Post-nasal drip.
Post-nasal drip. Why does he have such a nasally fucking voice, too?
I don't have a nasally voice.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, I was probably wrong to hold my personal incredulity.
There's still no, there's still no evidence that what he's alleging happened. Just because he says, oh, okay, or human psychology, whatever, that's another aside. Like, do we have concrete evidence this is why the shooting occurred? Was one of the motives... I don't like Christians, and they have to die.
Well, some eyewitnesses claim that that's what happened.
Yeah, but they also did it in Columbine, too. That's how that basically surfaced before.
Right, I mean...
This is a narrative that conservatives have pushed before.
Exactly, yeah.
That's a very interesting question. It's not really interesting in the sense that it has a complex answer. It's interesting because it's so blatantly obvious. It's because he had a fucking weapon, dumbass. Now, see, here's the thing. What really got me...
Yeah, dumbass.
Dumbass.
Comparing some contrasting.
I mean, I don't know. I just feel like if I was in a big room of people... I mean, I got to go with Ben Carson because he got made fun of for this too, but he basically said, you know, in that situation, you should try to get everyone to just charge the fucking guy. I mean, yeah, I know. Some people are going to get shot. You might be among those shot, but you got a better chance of surviving if you fucking all attack this guy at once. I just, you know, rather than letting him systematically shoot people. I mean, you know, I don't see how that could even be argued. If everyone charged this guy, there's no way he could kill them all before they get him and pin him to the ground and beat the shit out of him and probably kill him.
You know, because if I were to have said the same thing about a rape victim,
listen to this.
As in, if you two were the only two people in the area, you could have, well, I mean, you could have avoided the situation altogether when a lot of times when it comes to rape, even if the person jumped out and attacked you. If I were to say, why didn't you fight back? Well, that would be victim blaming, wouldn't it? And...
I'm sorry, I don't see the point there. What?
That's just some total hypothetical situation inserted to be like, so your logic doesn't hold up. That's what he's basically trying to
say. Rape is nothing to do with this story. It's totally different. That analogy makes no sense.
Yeah, he's trying to use it as an analogy to do, like, basically say that's how you would feel.
Okay.
The interesting thing is, even in the course of me making these YouTube videos...
So because I think that... This room of people probably would have been better off attacking this guy.
You're victim blaming.
Because I said that, that means I also think that if a woman is raped by a guy that jumps out of a bush with a knife and grabs her, I also blame her by proxy. That makes no sense. That analogy totally fails. It's totally not true. You're a moron.
Videos. I've never said, in fact, I've said the opposite numerous times, that it's never your fault if you get raped, and I've never even said that it's a rape victim's fault, you know? And yet, to even suggest that, of course, from feminists and young ladies, you get lambasted.
So wait, he holds that point of view that he's analogizing to my point of view? Yet he's trying to justify his point of view while decrying my point of view? I'm very confused. This is all over the place.
You know, and yet this guy says something which is very clear and obvious reason as to why the Angels didn't fight back. They didn't fight back because they had no training, and they were in a stressful situation. And a lot of people, as you understand, fight or flight. And they couldn't run away, so they froze up.
Well, That doesn't make sense. You just said fight or flight, and they couldn't run away. So if they can't flight, fight should have happened by that logic. So obviously it was fight, flight, or
wow,
be paralyzed with fear. You
this
know?
Guy just fails and fails.
I don't even know what to say about
that. Happens a lot with people. They don't understand. They never dealt with stress. They never learned how to deal with these things. And these people.
I've never
fight,
dealt with stress.
Flight or freeze. No. No, no, no.
You know, I've never dealt with stress in my life. I've only had a gun held to my head 3 times. I've only been through 2 major natural disasters. I've only dealt with having to decide to pull the plug on my father after his super massive heart attack. But, you know, I've never dealt with any traumatic situations in my entire life.
Yeah, sounds accurate.
You know so much about me making that statement.
Dude, he's armchair psychology. He's got you figured out, man. He's got you figured out.
And by the way, Robert E. Lee was a fucking faggot.
Don't know how to disarm a gun. Of course, they're not going to fight back. It's not fucking rocket science. It's very obvious. Now, of course, I myself would fight back. Well, see, but then even then, that would depend on the entire scenario that's going on.
Well, he was about to say situation, but he changed the scenario.
He fucking read your mind, dude.
Individual. He knew. He knew.
I mean, if the person is at a distance to you, you know what I mean, it's going to take you some time to cross that distance. And if the individual has the gun already aimed and loaded at you, you're not going to make a move knowing that you can't fight back, that you're just going to get gunned down. I mean, either way it goes, you're going to die. So, do I guess the person just decided not to fight back because if they were in a scenario, they couldn't disarm the gun because they don't know how. Second, they're at a distance. Of course, a gun, as we all know, shouldn't really have to explain this, is a long-ranged weapon. So, no one intelligent usually has a gun at a close range to an individual for it to be disarmed, not unless you're either trying to intimidate somebody, or, well, unless you're pulling it out to get ready to get some distance. You don't normally shoot someone at point-blank range. Normally. That's not what a gun is for. So I would imagine that there had to be some distance
away.
Between him and the person, otherwise they probably would have tried to fight back. Or if they
rifles,
didn't, because they had no training
guns,
in
I mean, not really. It's...
gun disarmament.
Sure.
So, I mean, in all honesty, it's not confusing at all as to why no one fought back. No one asked the question as to why didn't a woman fight back a man who was trying to rape her.
Okay, an entire classroom of people...
It's a false equivalency.
...that can see what is happening and can see that they're being slaughtered like animals... I think is a bit different than a woman who is just suddenly surprised with an attack that with a rape attack. I mean, that's not analogous. Now, I agree that there were flaws with the statement that I made. I was a little bit too overbearing. I didn't really consider all of the ramifications of group psychology at the time. But your refutation... is terrible.
Well, take a look at 9/11. Remember, the first planes to hit, people just thought these guys wanted money or had some other agenda, so they're like, okay, well, we're just going to be on a tarmac and hopefully, you know, we can survive. They don't even have guns. You know, we don't even know what they want. And then after the other, some of the people learned, I think it's the flight they crashed in Pennsylvania or wherever, when they learned that, no, these people were killing people and crashing planes into buildings, they attacked them.
Yeah, it was no longer worth it at that point, you know.
And I'm sure some of them were killed in attacking them and taking over the plane. I'm sure some of them were gravely injured, but they still did it.
Yeah,
like,
nobody
well,
knows. Nobody will know what happened on that plane.
Yeah, no, we have no idea. We just know that they were not successful as far as...
I just assume that the Paul Greengrass movie
I'm guessing the pilot was dead.
Yeah, the pilot... I think the pilot... Well, I think the terrorists had taken over the plane at that point.
Mm-hmm.
And then they just decided, you know, to charge them because they realized, I think through cell phones and stuff, like, hey, yeah. These guys are crashing planes into buildings. They're not just... you know, going to let you go. They're suicide attacks. Yep.
Suicide pills.
She has no training in the area, and the nigga was stronger than her. Why didn't they fight back? The nigga had a gun, they couldn't disarm him. It's very simple.
Okay.
Right? It's not fucking rocket science.
Yeah, it is. As it turns out, after recording this video, I learned that someone did try to fight back. He was an Army veteran named Chris Mintz. He was shot a total of 5 times and is recovering in the hospital. Reports say he's going to have to relearn how to walk.
Yeah, so someone actually did. Yeah, I remember this being a story now that you mention it.
Yeah, but he was just one guy trying to go up against an armed gunman. And my whole thing is, didn't they all attack?
Well, he did have some. He had military training and experience, so.
Yeah.
That trains you to run towards gunfire, not away from it. So that's why he obviously did this. Not everyone who's in the military would, of course not. But he obviously did. So
I'm not sure if it's going or not.
Yeah, it's probably
okay.
Done.
There we go. Oh wait, no, it's not done. Let's get back to the video.
I mean, I don't know what the layout of the room was. I don't know how the situation was orchestrated. I wasn't there
situation.
To see it. But that just seems very strange.
Again, it would be rather strange if I said I don't know why the woman went into a secluded area.
What does this
with
have to do with what we're talking about?
It has
about.
Nothing
this
to do with
it. It's a total
it.
Aside.
It's totally not relevant.
He's like,
you know, but the guy doesn't know.
It's my airtight argument.
Yeah, this is not an airtight argument.
And odd. That's victim blaming. Just to be clear.
It's not like he's like basically
you're
repeating some action.
But if that narrative is true, and I guess that, you know, other than my incredulity, I don't have any evidence that it isn't.
There you go. You already said that.
Yeah, you're right. I guess I don't regret saying it because I did kind of, not preface it, but follow it up with, you know, basically, don't take this too seriously. This is just an argument from incredulity.
And this might sound fucked up at first, but I think Christianity is kind of culpable in this.
Now, see, that's what I'm saying here. Could you imagine if I ever would have said...
Is he really going to go back to the rape thing again? Wow.
This might be a little controversial.
He really thinks this is a good analogy, doesn't
yeah.
he? It's not. I'm sorry.
But maybe it's your fault. It's amazing. I'll tell you why it's amazing when we wrap the video up.
First, in the sense that people were willing to trade this faith in a God that does not even exist for their very lives.
Again, women are willing to trade their safety for some fun or for some pleasure.
You're so stupid.
Huh?
You are so fucking stupid. That is just the most absurd. Like, that is not even vaguely fucking comparable. I'm sorry. It's not comparable. Christianity is a massive social institution that basically, usually the way people get into it is they're brainwashed into it from fucking birth.
Or they target people who are like down and out and like, hey, you know what? Magical man in the sky gonna make everything better. Just follow these rules.
And we're talking about a social institution. We're talking about me blaming an ideology for people dying. What you're talking about is someone being held personally responsible for being the victim of a crime.
Same thing.
Totally not analogous.
Same thing, TJ. Come on. You're being destroyed.
Yeah. I'm victim-blaming,
though. You know, once you realize he's shooting Christians, say you're not a Christian.
Once you realize that you lose your inhibition when you drink, stop drinking.
This proves nothing. This literally proves nothing.
I love the look on your face.
Holy shit.
I love the look on your face.
This is one of the worst arguments I've really ever
is
heard.
Is it even an argument? What is even... I don't even understand the point that he's trying to make here.
But no, apparently they thought, well, maybe if I deny Christ, I'm going to go to hell. So I guess I'd better say I'm a Christian.
Yeah. No, honestly, I'd say that's courage. You'd be something of a coward if you decided to opt out like that.
No, that's really dumb.
No, it's actually the smart thing to do.
Let me explain why. Because here, it's just a very simple risk-benefit analysis, all right? The benefit, if you're a Christian, the benefit of lying and saying, no, I'm not a Christian is...
You can ask for forgiveness.
You get to live. You get to see your family. You get to go home. You get to make amends with God if you really need to. Life goes on. You can still continue to support your family and be there for your friends and experience the world.
It's better to be dead.
If you say, yes, I'm a Christian, all that happens is you get shot in the fucking head.
You're shot in the head for
what
Jesus.
What kind of fucking retard would want to make that decision?
A Christian retard, TJ. A Christian.
No, it's courage.
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 That's not courage. That's stupidity.
Courageous
that
Christian.
That is absolute
you
fucking
what,
stupidity.
You know what, TJ? You're going to burn a lake of fire for all time. Let's see who has the last laugh then, buddy. There's all those Christians in heaven laugh at you. Ha ha, TJ. Hell isn't real, huh?
I would look at that individual as a coward.
Well, then you're a moron.
Just saying,
but we already knew that. Yeah. Well, I see you as
lack
a retard.
Conviction.
That was a... the chime of the angels, in case you guys heard that. That was God chastising me. It wasn't Scotty's cell phone at all.
You guys probably couldn't hear it, but there was a chime. It's not important.
It is important, actually.
Another thing, Chris Harper Mercer said that he would be welcomed into hell and embraced by the devil. Now, I don't know if he was speaking allegorically or figuratively there.
It really doesn't fucking matter. Because
yeah, it kind of fucking does.
No, TJ, it doesn't matter. He doesn't think it's important, so it doesn't matter. It's not relevant to the story, even though it is.
Because
why would the shooter's beliefs matter? Even though the issue of
Satan, the old serpent, doesn't like humanity. If you study Christian theology, Satan, Azazel, Baal, Baphomet, no matter what demon you want to pick out, doesn't like people.
Why not?
Because
your book that you purport to treat as the unerring word of God says so, so that's a reliable source. Like, okay, so let's even assume you buy into this. Why would the Bible be kind to Satan, where it's like, you know what, Satan, yeah, he's a dick, but he's, you know, he has his flaws, but he's an okay guy. Come on!
Yeah, I mean, like, lots of people have different theological interpretations of these characters like Jesus and Satan and God and whatever other gods have existed in whatever other religions. You know, not everyone's interpretation is the same. For you to sit there and say, Satan doesn't like people, I think you could make a very compelling argument that Satan likes people better than God does. He kills way less people in the Bible, for one thing. He actually gives us the knowledge of good and evil, which apparently is so important to our sense of free will. Lucifer does actually mean morning star, and that can be translated to light bringer, by the way. There's been plenty of people who have advocated for Satan, and who have advocated for... I mean, and also, by the way, the fact that Satan doesn't like people, kind of irrelevant considering we're talking about a guy who shot people being inspired by Satan. I think he might suspect that Satan doesn't like people. That's why he's killing people for Satan, you know?
At all. They...
Oh, you're so laughable, TJ.
It's laughable, really, to think that such a demonic, evil creature who hates humanity... would welcome you into the depths of hell when his entire mission is to try to convince you to go there. You know?
Why? Well, that makes perfect sense. That he would embrace, if he wants you to go there, yeah, him embracing you when you get there does make sense. What do you mean it doesn't make sense?
I mean, hell itself, and according to Christian theology, is a place that was actually created for Satan because of his... betrayal against God. For some odd reason, a lot of people don't know
okay,
that.
Okay, so then God wants people to go to hell.
God created for people. No. It was created for Lucifer because of the rebellion.
But people can still
in,
go
in
there.
Heaven. That's why. Hell is not a place
this
for
is,
people.
This is just one interpretation of theology of many.
Oh, yeah. This isn't just like there's one version of Christianity.
You're acting like there's some definitive narrative here, and there isn't. There simply is not.
Yeah, the world is no longer like everyone's Catholic or everyone's this. There's so many different branches of Christianity.
I mean, I don't know if it's ever been that way.
And also Judaism and Islam.
And I guess, you know, the reason why people think that is because a lot of fundamentalist Christians don't understand that part of their own theology. I guess because reasons.
Oh, okay. It's not that they don't understand it. It's just they have a different interpretation. There's many different interpretations. Are you really this fucking stupid?
The right interpretation. We hear this all the time. Like, if people only understood our true position, then they would agree.
Anyway, you're missing the entire point, which is that what religion has propagated the idea that this entity called Satan actually exists.
He looks so high right there, like
he must be high on his own bullshit. I think he fucking inhaled some jankum or some shit. Anyway, let's move on. He's a piece of shit and he's retarded.
You love him.
No, I don't.
You love him, TJ. You're a victim blamer.
Well, I blame him for making me a victim of his stupid bullshit.
So I get annoyed by a lot of things. And I thought, as a sort of cathartic exercise, that I would share some of those things with you. So, here's a few of the things that I've hated recently.
Okay.
The first thing I hate is sexist music, which...
me too.
...has been annoying me a lot more than usual recently. And this started off with Tame Impala's new song, I'm a Man, which essentially says, I'm a man, I don't think before I do things, which can be construed in a lot of ways, but one of those ways can be rape apology, because it's
oh
one.
Oh my god!
Wow! Of course,
what one of those a possible fucking ways. Stretch.
It's possible.
I'll tell you what. When he puts out a song called "Rape Is Okay," then you can fucking say this is a rape apologist song. When it's like. It's okay to rape a bitch, because it don't fucking matter. You know, and that's the fucking song. You could be like, this song is fucked up.
Yeah.
But this thing about men don't think before they act, therefore this song, one of the things it could be talking about is rape apologism, so...
It's the same thing, TJ. The media pushes this agenda on us.
It's just such a... The rape agenda. You cannot see how fucking much of a stretch that
is. The rape lobby, TJ. The rape lobby is here.
The rape lobby.
Yes. It's... TJ, look, we live in a rape culture. There's a rape lobby, obviously.
It's like the check-in at the rape hotel. Welcome to the rape lobby.
One of the things that people often think that, for some reason, men can't control themselves. And I've talked about this in, I think, my catcalling
video. These men know what they're doing.
But it's the same
thing. They're monsters.
And putting these messages out in popular media is just...
It's
not okay. It's just... apology for horrible
it's not
things.
Okay.
So did she just say that men can't control themselves?
No, she's saying that there's an idea out there in popular culture
a
that
dangerous
men
idea.
Can't control themselves, and therefore men get away with stuff.
This is why...
I've never heard anyone successfully use that as a defense for doing something fucked up.
TJ, this is why we need the Anita Sarkeesian seal of approval.
I've never heard someone, like a judge, say, well, how do you plead? It's like, Your Honor, I didn't even think before I murdered those people. It's like, oh, okay. Case dismissed. You're free to go. You weren't even thinking about it.
I think
so.
All that would do is knock it down to second degree murder if they believed you.
And it's stupid. And what I realized with this is that it's not like sending out a tweet, 30 seconds of work, and then it's out there for everyone. This is a song, or all sexist songs, go through so many different people along the chain of production that it's insane to me
who
that
all
nobody
embrace misogyny
along this process
totally
went,
and utterly.
That's a sexist song. We can't put that out into the universe.
Maybe someone did say that, and then that person, they were just like, hey, that's retarded. Please go the fuck away and never try to give us your opinion again.
Hopefully they were laughed out of the room.
Yeah, and then spit on, and bricks were thrown at them as they tried
bricks.
To get out of the car.
You must have bricks.
Like, how?
Was that you blowing your brains out? Because
I'm saying her mind is blown, too.
It doesn't make any sense. Another thing that I hate that I'm going to complain about is people complaining about how long it takes to get their food in the McDonald's drive-thru. Like, seriously? We are all here because we're too lazy to, one, make our own food, and two, get out of our damn cars to go and get that food.
Here's the fucking thing, though. The reason people go to McDonald's is because it's supposed to be fast.
But it's not.
That's why it's called fast food, you stupid fucking moron.
You guys ever gone to a self-checkout and you scan something and you put it in a bag, but it doesn't think it's there? So
yeah, I think it's pretty reasonable.
You know,
Look, I went to McDonald's. I was the second car in line. It took like 25 minutes. That is, I'm sorry, ridiculous. I know it's not very important in the grand cosmic scheme of things, but it certainly should be faster than that.
I love how there's important political issues. Like, you could just be a total, like, totally apathetic, but then McDonald's wait time. She's like, and we have had enough in this country. We're going
to
improve McDonald's wait times.
Take a stand.
We're going to start a law. We're going to enact a law in the Constitution. If you have to wait more than 3 minutes, your food is free.
That's a good law, man. I'd vote for it. I would. I'd vote for that shit.
Like, you can't complain
yes,
about
I can,
service
asshole.
Taking too long. Like, do you know how long it would take for you to make your own goddamn food? A lot
too
longer
long.
Than the 10 minutes that you've been sitting in your car listening to the radio
on,
waiting
well,
to be fed.
Well, it depends on how long it's taking. I mean, if it takes 30 minutes to get a fucking cheeseburger from McDonald's, I think that is worthy of complaint.
Yeah, and, you know, a lot of times they do take that long, so fuck you, bitch.
Another thing is something that I've never understood, and it's people who make fun of other people's clothing. Or tell them that they don't like their clothing.
Remember that time that all those feminists decided they didn't like that guy who worked for NASA's clothes because they had sexy women on it?
Oh.
You mean like that time? Was that one of the times that annoyed you? You stupid, fucking empty-headed, vacuous fucking moron.
These feminists fucking judge everyone.
From the seventh circle of fucking feminist hell.
They judge everyone's appearance, and they judge every little detail about a person because that's how they want to play. Like, these are the gotcha people. We want to talk about these. All these media people are gotcha people. These are the real gotcha people. Any little difference, any little thing they can find. They're going to point out. It's like, oh, well, this person happens to be half black. You're a terrible person and a racist, and also they're gay, so you're also a homophobe now. And you know what? If you're a homophobe, you're definitely transphobic, and they just go on and on with these labels they can give you.
She's a moron.
Lots of phobias.
Like, seriously? Why? It's not your clothing. You don't have to wear it. Stop it. If a t-shirt is offensive, call someone out on it. That's a good thing to do. But if you
How would they call you out on being a fucking moron?
Oh, okay. So the exception is if the clothes are offensive, then it's...
Which could be anything. Anything.
I'm offended by your clothes. I think they support rape culture.
You know what I tell them? I'd say, look the fuck away.
Face. Look at her face.
Look away from my clothes
do
if they offend
a screenshot?
You.
Yeah.
Screenshot.
You have to remember, feminists have a right to never be offended or upset by anything.
Moron, she is a moron. Yes, he's a moron.
What a moron.
Yeah. Just don't like the way someone dresses? Why? You don't have to wear their clothes. Stop it. Like,
I have to look
do
at
not
them, though.
Comment on
especially
anyone
no
else's clothes
sense.
Unless it's to say, wow, man, I love your clothes.
So, okay, so you're allowed to like their clothes, but you're not allowed to dislike their clothes. How about, fuck you, I'm allowed to think and say whatever the fuck I want. How about that for a rule, you stupid fucking moron, idiot, retard.
Misogynist. He's a misogynist.
Pile of fucking
misogynist.
And insipid notions. You're so
dude,
fucking
you're so
dumb.
Clearly a fucking misogynist.
You're so
painful.
Fucking stupid.
TJ.
You have the best clothes I've ever seen in my entire life. The last couple of things that I'm going to talk about are...
And her clothes are garbage.
Things
clothes
that
are terrible.
I hate to no end. That have been annoying the crap out of me recently. Things that are so driven by ignorance and stereotypes. And
so
these are
you.
People who either don't support feminism because they're not women, or don't support Black Lives Matter because they're not black. Feminism benefits everyone. Just as it's fighting incredibly entrenched sexism for women,
not at this
it's
point.
Doing the same for men.
Yeah, you know, it benefits me so much when people like you feel like they have the right to tell people they're not allowed to make fun of clothes or make music that you deem sexist. You know, giving you the ability to censor art and media and shit, that just so benefits me, you know? It actually doesn't, you fucking idiot. I mean, just everything you say is like fucking a nail being pounded into my head. I mean, it's just so fucking frustrating and annoying listening to you speak. You're just the antithesis of all that is good in the universe. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck
you. You're a misogynist.
You.
Look at this misogynist white male have a breakdown on air.
And it's doing the
disgusting.
Same for all genders.
Feminism she's so
is
fucking
about
retarded.
Equality of the sexes. Equality
of course, TJ.
Of all genders. Pick
you
up
would
a
say that about a very
because
intelligent,
feminism,
smart
yes, it started
young
as a
woman.
Movement for women. Because
You ready for Brett Keane to come back yet? TJ?
Hey, oh, no.
Do you like the new lineup?
I think Brett Keane and this chick should get married, man.
Women, historically, have been so incredibly oppressed. And that leads me into the second
historically,
thing.
Historically, sure.
White people who don't support Black Lives Matter.
In some
you're
parts
a part of
the world,
human
sure.
race. act like it. People who think that Black Lives Matter is a controversial issue or a controversial slogan. Like, seriously? Yes, Black Lives Matter. People matter. Human lives matter, okay? And the fact that we treat people differently because they genetically have a different skin color to us, or they're from a different socioeconomic background, or they're just different in general.
Okay, Black Lives Matter, yeah, I mean, like, some core ideas are good, but yeah, there's a lot of them that are pretty fucking stupid.
Yes.
The strange thing is, by going into genetics, it almost sounds like she's making, like, a bell curve argument where it's like, if you look at black people, they're actually inferior. It's like, there's not much genetic difference. Very, very little.
This, I mean, like, Black Lives Matter has done some fucking stupid shit. There's no denying it. You can be against that movement and still believe in racial equality, all right?
It's just a total straw, man. It's like you have to, it's basically you have to believe
this.
I mean, my
personal position is I'm kind of on the fence about Black Lives Matter. I've never heard of them doing something so heinous and horrible that I'm just totally against them, and I do like the core message. But I have definitely heard some things that made me say, oh, come on, that's fucking stupid.
Is bullshit. And we can say as much as we want to that we don't need Black Lives Matter and we don't need feminism because all people are equal now. But that's not true.
I'll tell you the exact problem with the slogan Black Lives Matters. And it's basically this. If the principle, they have the principle that all life matters, or basically just like who gives a shit. And I mean, I know people have to say it's a false dichotomy in a way, but to me, it's like life. There's life or death. There's not really like a much choice. Like, oh, you can be in a coma or something.
Hashtag TJ's life matters. Hashtag no one else.
Well, like, let's stop police brutality and like, obviously, I understand what their argument. Like, look, the reason we want to say Black Lives Matter is because we feel we're being disproportionately affected. And I see an argument behind that. If that's what the people want to call their group, I mean, they should have every right to do it.
TJ, where is your white
guilt? And you don't have to agree with everything they do. And I mean, I doubt that it's like an organization that's run with, like, you know, a CEO or, you know, a leader that makes all the decisions for it. I'm sure it's a bunch of different people adopting this, phrase or slogan.
Incredible need for these movements because these people are treated like minorities when they're not. These people are still oppressed.
Black people actually are a minority.
Yeah.
To incredible extents. And they're... Every movement in their lives is affected by this oppression. And that's why we need movements like Black Lives Matter, like feminism, like the LGBT movement, which is part of feminism, which is part of Black Lives Matter.
No, what? Feminism is not the all-encompassing shield in which everything else rests on.
The LGBT movement is part of feminism? No. Wrong, incorrect, moron.
Matter. All these things connect to each other in different ways. All no. These issues are connected, and they should all be supported. So there you go. There is my list of things that I've been hating recently.
People should evaluate issues.
Here's like my list of things I've been hating recently. You. The end. What's next? I think we have time for one more video.
One more video.
Let's see.
You're angry tonight, TJ.
I'm not angry.
This is a debate.
Much anger I sense in you, TJ.
This is a debate that happened a few years ago between two people that were running for governor in Idaho. And it's amazing the crop of candidates that they get running for governor of Idaho.
Oh?
Yeah.
All right.
This is,
welcome to the Idaho debate.
I think I've seen this before.
On the 2014 primary ballot.
I want to welcome the candidates, Harley Brown,
Governor
C.L. Butchwater, and Senator Russ Fulcher. Harley Brown is a former commanding officer of Naval Construction Forces, a professional engineer, and
I feel
a
like
public
we played
works
this on the show before.
Did we?
I'm pretty sure.
I think
while
a while ago we
a high
did.
Hold
grad.
On.
Yeah.
Let's do this one instead, then.
My two
fuck.
Jewish parents
Brother Nathaniel.
Took me to Hebrew school when I was 6 years old.
We
this was in
it.
Addition to attending Sabbath services every Friday evening and Saturday morning, which also included Sabbath school. You see, Jews educate their children from the cradle. Although I was steeped in Yiddishkeit,
definitely
that
don't
is
do that.
The Jewish experience, throughout my growing up years, my fondest memory was singing Christmas carols with my Gentile friends. Every December, we would go.
So basically, this guy, when he was a little kid, he was a Jew, but he didn't like being a Jew, and now he's a grown-up, so he's like, fuck Jews.
I was indoctrinated. It's like, yes, other religions have never done this.
No other religion indoctrinates people like the Jews.
That's how fucking religion works.
I mean, look, the Jews, I mean, maybe for their kids they indoctrinate them, but for the most part, they're not out there looking for new converts and shit. There's a reason why there's only like 6 or 7 million Jews on the entire fucking planet, you know? Oh, yeah. This guy sucks. I'm gonna fucking find something different since Ben is gone. Can't find the fucking mouse, though. Oh, well, fuck it.
Go door to door throughout the neighborhood, singing Christmas carols such as O Come All Ye Faithful and Silent Night.
Come all ye faithful into Jesus' asshole.
Hey, if you'd like, I do have some Craigslist ads.
Let's do the Craigslist.
All right.
Craigslist ads!
Yeah, that's it, baby.
Yeah. God, Craigslist ads. So sexy.
I love it. Don't want to jack off alone. Let me help. Chubbs only.
Chubby chub.
Ready now. Hold my dick, and I hold yours, and talk shit, or whatever comes to mind that turns you on. I'm game for whatever ass play is good, too. If you like to have a finger in your ass when coming, M down, no fems. I'm a chubby chaser. Stocky is cool. To just not skinny, let's do this. I can meet you at your place, car play, or meet at a dark park by
oh
you
God.
And bust one or two nuts.
A bust a nut, literally.
How come none of these people who write these crazy perverted Craigslist ads have any grammar skills at all? Why is it always fucking retards?
Who else looks to Craigslist to get laid?
I guess that's a good point.
They're retards looking to fuck retards.
Retards yeah. Look
retards for seeking retards.
Retards seeking a retard. I gotta respond to this one.
You know what? I think this one.
Yeah, it is around here.
There you go.
Sweet.
Damn, TJ. I think it's only appropriate you read this one just because of the title, TJ. I mean, it's accurate.
BBC looking... Wait. BBC needs fat ass to fuck. D1... Is that D1 or DL?
DL, I think.
DL big. Dick thug looking for smooth, big booty bottoms to cone over and handle some real good dick, pick for pick. Looking now, no hairy or masculine, not my thing. 9 in, cut, your picks get mine, bitch.
Sorry, TJ, too hairy.
Oh, man, I could shave.
You can shave, well, get on.
Shave my
better get
hairs.
On it.
I can go to the waxing salon.
Let's see this one.
Ben.
Where's this one out of? Fayetteville, North Carolina.
So if you're in Fayetteville, here you go.
Here you go.
Daddy looking for them youngins. That's freaky. Not looking for intercourse. And if you ain't got big man hang-ups, I can't do it. I don't know how to do it.
I would say keep doing it. You're doing all right.
I'm 6'1", 290 pounds, down with some baby oil, rubbing, grinding, humping dick, on that ass, between thighs, nipple licking safe session with 18 to 30, what the fuck is this, what am I reading,
I don't know,
with 18 with 8 with 18 to 30 yellow red oh okay slim to muscular boys. You know what? It makes it hard to read.
Donation made if not too crazy. I host only. We'll only respond to emails with pics and age. Gotta see who's coming to crib. If you scared or just lay on bed, please don't respond. If you got a little freak and no big man hang-ups, hit me up now. Be ready to come over when you hit me up. If you get no response, you didn't send pics, age.
Seems pretty reasonable.
You gotta read the next one.
Fine. Man, 65, wants to meet smooth, hairless, 18 to 21-year-old, male for male, in Cork.
They're all male for male.
Where the fuck is Cork? I don't know.
Ireland?
Oh, it's in Ireland?
Yeah.
Fucking weirdos. And this person is, yep.
Yep.
I am a young at heart, married 65-year-old, last week. Damn, you got married last week and are looking for this shit? And wish to meet an 18 to 20-year-old boy to be treated as a bottom in a hotel in Cork / Dublin or Galloway. He's flexible with locations. Hairless and sissy preferred and must be totally obedient and submissive. BJ and Ramin expert in must, but can train. Love to make you pregnant. Hate to break it to you, guy, but it's not going to happen.
Well, he's going to try, damn it. He's going to fucking try. Why didn't you read it in a thick Irish accent, Scotty?
Because I can't do a thick Irish accent, TJ. Aw,
you're garbage.
Do one right now. Go.
I don't have to do that.
Go.
I don't have to.
Put up or shut up, TJ.
No.
Put up or shut up.
I don't have to do it.
Do it. You don't have to, but I'm asking you right now. I'm challenging you, TJ. You're being challenged.
Just read it like the Lucky Charms leprechaun.
He's not. Is he Irish? Yeah, I guess he is.
Yes.
You fucking idiot. Of course he's fucking Irish.
Yeah. I don't know.
Oh, choke.
All right. Are we done?
Are we done? Yes.
Yeah.
If you enjoyed this, give it a thumbs up. We'll see you guys on Wednesday.
Subscribe, bitches.
Wednesday, we're going to have your friend forever, Evan LeFevre.
God himself will be on the show. God himself.
You wanted the best.
If you want to see God,
yep.
Right here.
God is coming.
Good night.
Good night. Thumbs up. Subscribe. Thumbs
fuck
up.
Fuck you, TJ. You're garbage.
Scotty. Bitch.